Stroll and lost the game. And the Dodgers headed to St. Louis, leading 2-0. In game three, the magic returned in St. Louis for Terry Fenelon, making a brilliant play in the Dodger bullpen and an even better play to save game three for St. Louis. In game four, Jerry Royce was all thumbs. He couldn't come up with the ball. He couldn't come up with his first league championship win, and the Cardinals came up 12-2. And that's good. And this is how they feel as they come to game six. NBC Sports presents the 1985 National League Championship Series. Today from Dodger Stadium, the St. Louis Cardinals versus the Los Angeles Dodgers. Brought to you by Miller Beer. Miller made the American way since 1855. By Ford and your local Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? By Ralston Purina Company, makers of Purina Pet Foods and other fine products from Checkerboard Square. And by IBM and the growing family of IBM personal computers. Of the National League Championship Series between the St. Louis Cardinals, winners of three, and the Los Angeles Dodgers, winners of two. Hi, everybody. I'm Vin Scully, along with Joe Garagiola. There's a string now of 13 straight home victories in the National League Championship Series. Oral Hershiser hasn't lost here 12 straight. Is there such a thing as a law of averages?
Well, I would think that there is because statistics say there is, but I don't think ball players believe it that much because you still have to play the game. That's the important thing, and it comes down to today.
Joaquin Andujar has not pitched well, and well, since he won his 20th game. If you were Tommy Lasorda before the ball game, would you get on his case? Would you try and make him blow whatever cool he might have?
Absolutely. I'd pick out guys who I knew were at pretty good needles, and I would try to bench jockey him. I would have guys trying to bunt. I would have guys scrutinize every move he made. Like, I'd play off the line one tough Dominican. I'd remind him of the year he had. I would do everything. And it's up to Andujar to be in such control. He says, hey, I know they're going to do that. I'm going to pitch my game and not let anything bother me.
What about Oral Hershiser? Do you think the Cardinals would do anything differently? He was in trouble in the outset. Definitely looked like he was a victim of some pressure his first time out, but he got off the hook.
Well, he was a victim of the hype. He didn't pitch within himself, and he said it, and he knew it, and I think it'll be different today for him.
I think the mental part is going to play a big part in today's ball game. We'll check the starting lineups and have a lot more, all coming up right after this.
You're about to learn why Ford Escort, the world's best-selling car, is out to become even more popular. If all of this seems like a lot to remember about Ford Escort, let us sum it up for you.
Get 8.8 financing on 4 and 5 speed manual transmission Ford Escorts now.
Sorry, girls, but I gotta let some of you go.
Some working mothers are out of a job because you insist on eating Chex brand cereals without the milk. Don't you realize that Chex was designed to go with milk? Just enough milk gets trapped between the spaces to bring the true grain taste out while keeping the hearty crisp in.
Well, do you type?
So please, for them, for you, don't eat Chex without the milk.
The Kemper Cavalry. Why do so many people trust their auto and home insurance to Kemper?
First accident forgiveness. 10 for total. Repair or replacement value coverage for my new car, as long as I own it.
Guaranteed renewal for good drivers 55 and over.
Compare Kemper's loyal protection with anyone. We don't have to toot our own horn. Once you compare Kemper, you'll ride with us.
The following message furnished by Major League Baseball.
Set your sights on the best in baseball. Order the 1985 World Series program. It's chock full of facts with World Series rosters and history, and more than 100 pages of articles and photographs, making the World Series program a collector's item, and it's the same one sold at the ballpark. Send $6 check or money order to World Series Program, Box 8585, Trenton, New Jersey, 08650. That's Box 8585, Trenton, New Jersey.
This scene occurred just a couple of minutes ago, and it is rather unusual. As you can see, the Dodgers were introduced individually along with the starting team on the third base foul line. Whitey Herzog opted and refused to have his Cardinals introduced. The quote, which we have received about third hand, is that Whitey felt one introduction is enough, and since they had been introduced here back in game one, he didn't see any reason for them to stand out there for game six. So it is a lopsided scene, but it also picks up the thread of what we were talking about at the start, Joe. The fact that the mental part will probably play as big a part of this game as in any game played in quite a while.
I think there's some gamesmanship going on, and I heard that Whitey didn't want him out to the Cardinals because he didn't want them to get booed and the Dodgers to get cheered.
Well, here's the Cardinals who will play, and their sensibilities and sensitivities have been protected by their manager. Willie McGee in center field, Ozzie Smith, yesterday's hero at short, Tommy Herr at second, and Jack Clark in the cleanup spot at first. Andy Van Slyke in right, Terry Pendleton at third, Darryl Porter behind the plate. Tito Landrum is in left field, and Joaquin Andujar will be the pitcher. One other question, of course, it is called the League Championship Series. I would assume that the league president, Chubb Feeney, should have called the shots, and in a sense, Herzog's refusal kind of undercuts the league presidency.
Well, there's all kinds of talk. He also said that Whitey would not allow cameras if he won into the locker room, and they said, well, you can't stop that from happening. You saw the defense, but the key in the Dodger defense settles with that man right there, Hershiser. He's got a quick curve. He tries to change speeds more. He runs his fastball up and in. He throws cross seams to get it up and in. If he gets too fine before he has to and gets behind the hitter, he's going to be in trouble, but he's just got good stuff.
All three of his losses came on the road in a one-month span, June 8th in Atlanta, June 26th at San Diego, and his last loss, July 7th at St. Louis, 7-1. So Oral Hershiser against the Cardinals, and here's something he must contend with. The Cardinals have scored 15 runs in this series in the first two innings. The Dodgers have not scored in the first two innings. 4-1. One other very important note the history books tell us, never in a best of seven has there ever been a World Series where the home team won all seven games. And if you remember, the Dodgers won the first two games here. The Cardinals won the next three in St. Louis. And what the Dodgers are trying to do is break history and establish a precedent. And it's 2-1.
Might just add that the infield here is not as smooth, obviously, as that artificial surface in St. Louis. It's not as fast. A bit bumpy. It's chewed up a little bit. And the infielders will have to watch that ball a little more closely and watch it really go into that glove. You can't take your eye off for a minute.
2-1. And it's a ground ball to the left at Duncan. Big hop. He staggers, but gets him anyway. And the Dodgers have certainly done a magnificent job in shutting down the league's leading hitter. Willie McGee was hitting only 190 as he grounds out, so he'll give up some more points. One away, and here is the Wizard of Oz. Ozzie with that remarkable home run yesterday. Shocking, I would think, everybody in the baseball world. It should be pointed out, only Smith and Herr have hit in every game in the League Championship Series. They've each hit in all five. And he hits Hershiser very well. 6 for 14. Ball one.
Whitey had that great court. He said, what were you hoping? When Ozzie went up, he said, I would hope he'd hit one out. He said, well, how long have you been hoping that? He said, about 7 years.
This is for his family. We get his name up there with some of the big left-hand knockers the game has ever seen.
Well, Lasorda had a good point. He said, a little guy, Mel Ott was a little guy. He hit 511. Joe Morgan was a little guy. He hit a ton of them. Size doesn't mean that much when you've got power, but, of course, he's not known for power, Smith.
The bunt up along third. Hershiser can't barehand it. I think he would have had enough time to field the ball with his glove, but he opted to barehand and couldn't do it, and it's going to go as a bunt single.
You can really deaden the ball here, as opposed to you see the delivery. The ball really is dead right here. It doesn't come up, and he could have gotten it with the glove. I think either way, too late. Smith had a base hit all the way.
So Ozzie Smith standing at first, and Hershiser trying to keep the Cardinals away from home plate. By the way, we talked about the Cardinals scoring 15 runs in the first two innings. In those games in which they scored, they're 3-0. Ozzie has stolen 31 bases during the regular season. Here's Tommy Herr. He's hit in five straight. Ball one. Tommy Herr having a big championship series against Hershiser. He's hitting 286. And now with the bunt single by Ozzie, the Cardinals have had a base hit in the first inning in five of the six league championship games. They failed to get a hit in the first inning of the Jerry Royce game, ironically, and then came back with nine runs in the second inning.
Mike Socia really asking that bench to give me some help, not only in the pitch outs, but if the runner goes, because he screamed.
Big bouncer to Brock Powell.
One of the difficult plays for a catcher on a steal play is when you have a tall left-handed batter up there. There's no position you can get into where you can see that runner, and the guys on the bench, they're just sitting there watching the game. You ask them to holler. All you got to holler is, there he goes.
There's a couple of other things to point out about, especially here at Dodger Stadium now. The home field advantage is almost non-existent. You got to remember, it's only 12 minutes past 12. The temperature is in the 80s. Most people are at work. And the ballpark is not even close to being full. And you want to talk about laid back. It is downright quiet here. You can understand the combination of the heat and the time of day. You can see all those empty blue seats and orange seats. It is just a bad time to play a big game. One ball and one strike. Ozzie has one stolen base, one for one in the league championship series. One and one to Tommy Herr.
Got a good lead.
Madlock shortened up at third. Missed the corner. Ball two. The plate umpire is Jerry Crawford. Dick Stello at first. Bruce Fremming at second. John McSherry at third. You have Paul Runge on the line in right. And Terry Tata on the line at left.
Here's a good shot of why the catcher is screened. When Herr gets in his position and Mike gets down, you'll see that he really cannot see that runner. That's great camera work, guys. That really shows it.
Two balls and one strike. One out, first inning, and we're just starting. Almost had too much daylight. He was leaning, but it was not a good throw to first. And again, as we have mentioned several times, that's the luxury of having a left-handed first baseman as opposed to a right-hander. The glove is right at the runner. Two and one. Ozzie showing signs of going on this pitch.
Manager's delight. I wish we could keep a statistic of how many times they run two balls and one strike. Catcher's in a bind. He's back there with handcuffs on. There's really nothing he can do unless he's guaranteed that he knows the sign.
He was only caught stealing second five times this year, and Hershiser's off the rubber. Greg Brock has a left foot that is half on the foul line and half in foul ground. At least his heel is in foul territory. Nothing said about it. Ozzie's not going. Ground ball to Sachs. He boots it, but they get a force on what's a perfect double play. So there it is. It'll never appear as an error, but it can be a monstrous kick.
He just booted the ball. Luckily, it stayed in front of him, and he was able to get the force, but lost a double play, which would have ended the inning.
He's very lucky that they did not have a play on where Ozzie Smith was going. Two balls and one strike, or you have two on and one out. So the Dodgers were fortunate that the Cardinals were not running, and the Cardinals are extremely fortunate that Sachs butchered that ground ball. So here is Jack Clark. Clark, 2 for 11 against Hershiser.
The degree of concentration for the infielders has to be so much greater on grass than it is on artificial surface. You just get, in fact, Red Janney's Cardinal coach says, hey, you can catch a ground ball with a pair of pliers on that artificial surface. They really shift on Clark.
That's in there.
Sachs, look where Sachs is, almost directly behind the bag. They play him, they punch him up the middle, a lot of room between first and second.
The outfield deep, Landro shaded over in the left center. So Tommy Herr at first, Herr during the regular year, stole 31 bases, busted bat, ground ball to Madlock, the quick way to Sachs, and they get the force. And for the first time in a while, the Cardinals fail to score in the first inning. And at the end of a half, Cardinals nothing, Dodgers coming up.
These guys came in here, wanted to buy us out. Wreck the place like the rest of the block. This guy's been our family for 70 years, so we said, go ahead, build your building. But build it around us.
There's still a place where some things are not for sale, where beer is beer and the brand is Miller.
To Miller's name, the American way.
Miller contains no additives or preservatives. Purity you can see, quality you can taste.
Miller's name, the American way.
Thinking of selling your home? Well, now may be the perfect time. Interest rates are at their lowest in years, and the Century 21 team has thousands of ready buyers. In fact, the Century 21 team sells more homes than any other. Want to sell your home? Call a Century 21 professional today and ask about a home market evaluation.
Put number one to work for you. Century 21.
Call now and let a Century 21 professional help sell your home.
So sumptuous and luscious.
Cheese, marvelous cheese.
Makes everything scrumptious.
For exciting new ways to make your meals sing, come on into your grocer's today. Get new cheese ideas and a great variety of real cheeses that'll get you cooking.
Glorious cheese.
Make your meals sing with real cheese.
It's a lovely picture of the Cardinal lineup, but of course they've already had their turn at bat. So why don't we see how the Dodgers stack up? And we'll begin with Mariano Duncan leading off at shortstop. And immediately the plate umpire Jerry Crawford going out to talk to Joaquin Andujar. And Crawford now is going over to the Dodger dugout. And it would appear as if he is calling, been called over by Tommy Lasorda.
It's the rosin bag. Andujar picked it up and threw it over to the Dodger dugout. And you have to have the rosin bag over there on the mound. Andujar didn't want it, and he just flung it over there. We've got some gamesmanship going on here. There's no question about it.
So we will be watching the Dodger dugout today while Andujar is pitching, you can bet. Meanwhile, they're bringing... Here's the Dodger lineup. Mariano Duncan opening up at shortstop, followed by Kenny Landro in center field, and then Pedro Guerrero in left. Bill Madlock in the cleanup spot at third, and Mike Marshall in right field. Mike Socia behind the plate. Greg Brock is at first. Steve Sachs will be at second. Oral Hershiser the pitcher. And the bat boy is now bringing a rosin bag out to the mound and has dropped it behind the rubber.
And Jerry Crawford is over talking to Lasorda. I mean, that's a good-sized rosin bag. Probably a line drive hit there and get a stop. Jerry Crawford is a plate umpire, and he's visiting with Lasorda right now.
And I just read part of what Lasorda said. I've never seen so many. And remember, we were talking about, I was reading Lasorda's lips the other day, and he said, you weren't at the meeting. And that was an accurate call. And he was explaining about extra people in the dugout. For instance, the Cardinals have
Johnny Lewis and Kepshire.
And the Dodgers have Ben Hines. And they had had a meeting that they'd be allowed to sit in the dugout. However, when Ben Hines got hollering at one of Paul Runge's calls, Bruce Fleming came in and talked to Paul Runge, who then talked to Lasorda, and Lasorda said, well, you weren't at the meeting. We agreed that we would allow those men to sit in the dugouts.
He said, we're waiting for something. Crawford did. I don't know. Obviously, they're waiting for something. I don't know what it would be. Duncan is ready. The pitchers are ready. All the players are out there. Read it, can you?
You know, there was a great book written years ago by an Englishman. And one was called Lifesmanship, and one was called Gamesmanship. For instance, in gamesmanship on a golf course, somebody makes a great shot, and he's your opponent. And so you say to him, you know what's great? Just as you're making contact, the way you gave your hip that little extra, now the guy's thinking, wow, that's what, man, you ruined his whole game, because now he's doing something that he wasn't really doing.
Yeah.
That was just part of gamesmanship. Lifesmanship, if you want to really put somebody down, let's say I come over to your house to visit, and you greet me at the door, and you know I'm dressed for the party, and you'll open the door and you say, hi, welcome, I know you'll want to wash. I think there might be a little gamesmanship going on here. I'm not sure. Whitey Herzog did not want his team to stand out on the first baseline. And we're not saying the Dodgers have answered him with some kind of trickery, but his team is standing out on the field.
Lasorda, Dick Stello is over at third base. There you see Stello. I would imagine they're waiting for the groundskeeper to do something. That's the last guy that that can be involved here. Stello's going downstairs to look for somebody. It may be that Andujar is not ready for the mound, and he doesn't like the way the mound is. It's too high or too wet or too something. And you can see in front of the mound how wet it is, and I'm sure the groundskeeper will come out, because when you can't blame it on the umpires, you find somebody else who's the groundskeeper. Now, it's dug out around there, and Andujar may have complained about it, and they fixed it for the hometown guy, Hershiser. He liked it.
I'm also looking for Joe Amalfitano. Manny Mota is standing in the Dodgers' first base coaching box, and there's no Amalfitano.
I'd stake it on the groundskeeper is what I'd stake it.
Well, here comes Chris Duca and a member of the crew. So we got something going on.
Oh, they're
going
to put some sand and pack it in some clay. I guess they thought that they had been fooling around with it. Usually it's in front of home plate that the groundskeepers work. And here they come. And Chris is going to get some national exposure. Millions and million dollars spent, and we're going to watch some guys do a little gardening here. Usually it's the landing area that they worry about, but apparently they got it so wet and packed in for Hershiser that it affected Andujar, and now they're going to correct it. And if that's not gamesmanship or lifesmanship or one-upsmanship.
Yeah, I'm reaching. I know the man who wrote it was an Englishman, and I believe his name was Potter, Stephen Potter. And he would have loved this, because this is right out of his book.
It's usually in front of home plate or the landing area on the mound, but here it's right at the mound, just a bit too wet. Now, they'll work on the landing area, too. You can see he's putting some down at the landing area. Chris is working in front. The other fellow is working on the landing area. And there you see where he dumped it, because it's the stride that affects the opposing pitcher.
You know, it's amazing. I remember in 1962, when the Dodgers and the Giants were in a bitter pennant race, and the Dodgers had to go and play in Candlestick Park. Walter Olson was the manager of the Dodgers. Alvin Dark was the manager of the Giants, and Maury Wills was the number one base runner. And the Giants literally flooded the infield to prevent Wills from stealing.
You can see when Andujar lands, now watch, he just barely gets to that sandy part right there. Now Hershiser, obviously his stride is bigger, and his heel would have dug in at the back end here, and Andujar just barely gets there, and that can really throw you off kilter. The landing area is so important. It's just like down the bullpen. Sometimes clubs, when they jockey around the infield, they would make the bullpen mound a little bit lower, a little bit higher. I guess the best doctors of the infield I ever knew were the Bosser family. Those guys were great, beginning with Mr. Bosser, Emil, and then Gene, and now his son over at White Sox. It's all part of it, and I don't say that the Dodgers were playing games here, but if they weren't, they've
because of all the raging fires in the area. The Dodgers have been away in St. Louis since Friday. And perhaps in trying to keep the field from burning out, the area's just got too wet. Whatever, we're going to the bottom of the first, and here's Mariano Duncan. A bunt foul on one.
You telling me dirt burns?
Dirt burns. I just meant they turned the water on.
Oh, yeah. I tell you, it's the game. It's the season right here, and you're going to do what you can.
Duncan, as you saw, with only one hit, and he has a little protective brace on his foot. He got that swinging against Andujar. Patano in the third base coaching box. There's the protective area to protect that shin bone. 1-1 to Duncan. Now back, 1-2. Mariano, as a left-handed batter, is 0-for-6 in the championship series. He hadn't done a lick from this side of the plate.
Andujar is not a finesse pitcher. He's a power pitcher. He will challenge you, and you'll watch him with the right-handed batters. He'll drop down. He'll come sidearm with both his fastball and his curveball. He'll challenge you.
The corners have backed off a little. They're not looking bunt, two strikes. And now he foul-tipped it at the plate, so he's still up there. Duncan is 1-for-10 lifetime against Andujar. That was a double in game two.
Three-quarter delivery.
The day before yesterday, when we were in St. Louis, Tommy Herr third, doubled home McGee and Smith against Valenzuela in the first inning. And Madlock dived at the ball and hurt his left thumb. It is a recurrence of an old injury, and that thumb is heavily taped. They wanted to x-ray it, and Madlock said, no, I don't even want to know what's wrong with it. I have to play. And he hits one up the middle. Bad thumb or otherwise. 1-0 Dodgers. And the Dodger bench going wild.
Both Guerrero and Madlock jumped on the first pitch, indication certainly being that they didn't want Andujar to get ahead of them at all, so they would have to face the sidearm. Three quarters, and right back up the middle, and you can see Andujar try for it, Porter rooting, but to no avail.
Now Mike Marshall with Madlock aboard in there. Remember, Landro took Andujar very deep to get Duncan to third, and that allowed the run to score unmolested. Marshall with four hits in 19 at-bats, hitting .211. Breaking ball, 1-1. The Dodger bench has settled back, leading 1-0. Marshall has not hit Andujar at all. The Cardinals are still, of course, in the driver's seat. Marshall hitting only .118 lifetime. He has only two hits in 17 at-bats. One of those two hits, however, was a home run.
Andujar is a quick release to first base. I mean, it's a better than average move. He's not going to take Madlock for granted. Madlock not known to steal bases, but can if you take him for granted.
Two out in the first inning, 1-0 Dodgers. Socia, the left-hand hitting catcher. Breaking ball on the count 2-2. For Bill Madlock, when he knocked in that go-ahead run, that is his sixth RBI in this league championship series. Tops for the Dodgers. And it would be tops for either team. Half a dozen.
Himself, man.
You know, if I were a pitcher, I would make him hang at the plate, because he's the type who tries so hard he almost turns to a pillar of stone if you left him there. 2-2. So after breaking balls away, he tried to come inside and missed, and he's gone all the way, which allows Madlock the edge of going 3-2 with two down, and puts a little extra heat on the Cardinal infielder.
And a hard lap to throw over there once or twice.
Madlock goes, and it swung on and missed. So Marshall strikes out. The Dodgers get one on a key single by Madlock. And at the end of an inning, Dodgers 1, Cardinals nothing.
You're a part of me. You'll be the catcher. Catch the heart of me. You'll be the catcher.
Your cat's a big part of your life, so make Purina Cat Chow brand cat food part of his life. It's all the nutrition cats need to help them live healthier, happier lives. What's more, veterinarians recommend it most. Purina Cat Chow, part of a healthier, happier life.
In the past, you saw a big Ford pickup carry a Chevy pickup up this monster mountain of boulders. But now we're going to top ourselves by carrying a Chevy and towing a Dodge pickup up the same mountain. Because this year, Ford has the most powerful lineup of V8 engines, gas and diesel, of any pickup. And only Ford has independent front suspension for ground-grabbing traction. No
wonder they're America's best-selling full-size pickups. The best-built American trucks are built Ford Tough.
Building a Tough starts with an oil-resistant sole bonded to a durable Goodyear weld. Then full-grain leather rubbers are double and triple-stitched together for strength and fully insulated for warm. Add a pillow-cushioned insole and a padded collar for comfort. Here's Texas Steel, on sale at Kmart, just $25. Similar styles available in wide lids. Now Texas Steel's an even better buy. You can't do better than Kmart, the saving place.
Sunday, join Alamo Joe for an adventure through time.
Stay cheap.
Sunday, on Amazing Stories.
The Goodyear Blimp Columbia, Captain Tom Mattis from Huntington Beach. A little over 60 years ago, when a Goodyear Blimp made its first postseason baseball appearance, the Cardinals defeated the Yanks in the World Series. Magnificent view and a bright blue sky, unfortunately, in all of the areas beyond the ballpark, and particularly in the west and northwest, heavy pall of smoke from all of the terrible fires that they have had. I think the last estimate I heard, over 70,000 acres.
Scary, isn't it?
Terrifying. Mm. One reason is Southern California averages, I think, 14 point something inches of rain a year. And here we are in the middle of October, and they've had 5 inches for the entire year. Mm. So it is bone dry.
Well, I know that Pepperdine area. Gina went there, and I said, that's beautiful. That's scary. Mountains up.
Bone dry except on the mound.
That's right.
Here's Andy Van Slyke and a ground ball to Sachs. He seizes the initiative. He wasn't going to wait for the ball to come to him. He charged it and made the play. Now, that's the thing we pointed out with Hershiser when he made his first appearance, and that is his ability to keep the ball down and, consequently, a lot of ground balls. If we get a lot of ground balls, you know he's on his game, as you saw Socia reminding everybody, including you at home, that Pendleton bunts.
And the broken bat. He's already gotten Clark with a broken bat. Ground balls and broken bats, and you say Hershiser has his good stuff. Not too fancy, but effective.
Pendleton hitting 250, takes a strike. But to break down that 250, he has done really all of his hitting as a right-handed batter. He's 1-for-8 from this side of the plate. 0-1. One ball, one strike. We're in the top of the second inning. Dodgers 1, Cardinals nothing. Terry with a protective shield guarding his right arm. And he bangs it back in.
It comes up for him and stays down. No chance. He takes two steps, braces himself, knows he has to make a hard throw, and does. And gets him by a full stride. That last hop really jumps up for him.
I'll tell you, there's only one other shortstop in the National League who makes that play, and it's Ozzie Smith.
Major League play.
So two down in the second inning as Duncan takes a sure base hit away from Pendleton. Speed to Darryl Porter, ball one.
Remember, it was one of our Game of the Week broadcasts. Duncan talked about how much playing on the grass, how you have to concentrate so much more.
That's in there. One ball, one strike. Top of the second inning. Dodgers leading 1-0. And that's hammered to center for a base hit. Landreau over to get it on the second hop.
That was a curveball. At least that's what the catcher signaled for, but it was not a curveball the way it was thrown. It was just a big flat wrinkle. It didn't have any bite at all to it. You could see Porter just kind of set himself and wait for it and then nail it.
Here's Tito Landrum. 5-for-10 with 4 runs batted in.
He developed this new stance with Dave Ricketts and Whitey Herzog. He'll put that bat in front of him, and when the pitcher starts back, he'll put it back on his shoulder right about now.
Ground ball to Duncan. He'll go the long way to Brock, and thanks to Duncan,
if you're waiting to buy a personal computer, you may have questions about power, expandability, and dollars and cents. For the complete answer, take a close look at IBM. An IBM PC runs thousands of programs, expands easily, and prices are better than ever. So don't wait. Once you take the first step, the rest come easy. IBM Personal Computers.
Gravy, gravy, it's Chuck Wagon Gravy. Chuck Wagon Gravy is here. The big taste of gravy. Chuck Wagon's bringing gravy. Chuck Wagon Gravy is here.
Chuck Wagon has a rich, thick, real meat gravy. A hearty stick-to-the-ribs gravy your dog will love. Chuck Wagon brand dog food from Purina with real meat gravy.
Yeah! Chuck Wagon Gravy is here.
Lister Mint with fluoride.
How come your mint is Lister Mint?
Aren't your teeth as important as your breath?
Scope and Signal don't have it, but triple freshening Lister Mint has fluoride because healthy teeth are as important as minty breath.
Maximum strength Sinutab with the three medicines you need to let you breathe again. To dry up runny nose, watery eyes, to relieve throbbing headache. Maximum strength Sinutab, the complete remedy for sinus or sinus cold.
This fall, NBC Sports has a November to remember when the starter's flag drops on the inaugural running of the CART Miami Indy Challenge. Racing's hottest drivers, Mario Andretti, the Unsers, and Indy champion Danny Sullivan battle it out for the national championship. A November to remember on NBC.
Bottom of the second inning, 1-0 Dodgers. We already gave you one note out of history. There has never been a World Series or best of seven series where the team won all seven at home, and yet that's what's happened in the first five games of the league championship series. Another note, as the Cardinals come in here leading 3-2, 12 times a World Series team led 3-2 and then lost. The last time that happened, Milwaukee led 3-2, and the St. Louis Cardinals beat him in 82. Ball one to Mike Socia. Joaquin Andujar gave up a double to Duncan and a two-out single to Madlock, and that's the run. In there, 1-1. Another note, as we had mentioned earlier, the home team has won 13 straight National League Championship Series games. You have to go back to a Dodger defeat here against the Philadelphia Phillies. 1-0. Ground ball to first. Clark is there. One away.
Watching Andujar pitch, you've been reading the papers today. They were getting on Whitey about how he mispronounces names, Hirschreiser and all that. I was in St. Louis, heard a little guy mispronounce Andujar. He just couldn't say it. He called him walking underwear.
Walking. Creeping underwear.
Walking underwear.
One out of the second inning. 1-0 Dodgers. Greg Brock. Now, there are two highly intelligent managers who are alternating or platooning men at a position. The Dodgers are platooning Cabell and Brock, and the Cardinals are platooning Cedeno and Van Slyke. How are they doing? Well, the platooning of Cabell and Brock, the Dodgers have two hits in 21 at-bats, admittedly one of them a home run. And for the Cardinals, coming in, Cedeno and Van Slyke were 3-17, and Van Slyke grounded out, so it's 3-18 now. That's the problem with platooning. You really never get any rhythm. You're jerked in and jerked out.
And you get the feeling that you have to get four hits every one time at bat if you want to stay in the lineup, and that's called pressing.
Ball three. Of course, you remember, Brock took Andujar into right field deep for the home run the last time they met in game two. Now, Brock, with his power, and especially with Sachs and Hershiser following, has probably gotten a 3-0 green light. He can swing if he likes the location. Way outside.
Steve Sachs.
Steve Sachs coming up. Remember, DeHaar will try to pick him off and throw it between his legs. And it went down the line, and eventually Sachs went all the way to third, and that was while Oral Hershiser was at the plate. And it eventually gave the Dodgers a big run. Sachs hitting .375 in the series with a half a dozen hits. Like a newborn baby.
They're going to kind of oil him down. You have to go out and break the mood constantly. And it's a matter of, and Mike Rourke is out there, who is kind of the guru, much like Hub Kittle was. Of course, Kittle had such a relationship with Andujar, and I almost felt they'd almost bring him back as a consultant because he even called him my daddy. But it's a case of throwing strikes because Sachs, not known for power like Ozzie Smith, you expect him to be punching that ball to the opposite fielder or even dropping a bunt for a base hit. There's one man out. He's not going to be up there sacrificing.
Sachs has hit right-handers 100 points better than left-handers, hitting over 300 against right-handers. Right. The problem, however, at least in the league championship series, in five games, Sachs has struck out four times. One of them was the day before yesterday in what appeared to be a bunt situation. Remember, it went 3-0, 3-1, and he struck out 3-2 on what most people felt was ball four. So we'll see if they put it on. 1-1 to count. You have the pitcher, Hershiser, on deck. And that's hit in the air to Van Slyke. Two down. So if nothing else, Hershiser will come up. And then if he makes the last out, you have the leadoff man starting off in the third. Hershiser, in his game that he won here, went 1-for-4. And you remember, bounced one over the head of Terry Pendleton for a big RBI single after he had twice tried to squeeze and failed.
This is quite a young fellow. He's really enjoying all this.
Fouled away.
They kid him about looking like he's his own x-ray. He's skinny this and skinny that. And I like that one line. He's a very devout young man. And they said, does it bother you to be so aggressive since you're a Christian? He said, you don't, just because you're a Christian doesn't mean you're a wimp.
Then he paused and said, that's going to get national publicity.
He's enjoying it.
Will be stopped at second. Van Slyke has a great arm.
And aggressive, that's the thing. He didn't take for granted that Brock would not go to third. He turned completely around, Van Slyke did, and he fired it to third base. You'll see an aggressive play here. Hershiser really serves it out there, and it looks like it would at least get Brock to third base. But watch Van Slyke as he picks it up. He doesn't hesitate. Back to the infield, he's firing it to third. And the reaction of Porter on that shot was kind of interesting. He turned his back to the mound and started walking back a couple steps.
Van Slyke has already shown us early in the series what a wonderful arm he has. And now with two out, the veteran Dominican against the kid Dominican. Ball one. And they are throwing now in the Cardinal bullpen. Bill Campbell is the right-hander. Ricky Horton is the left-hander. One ball, no strikes to Duncan. Two on, two out. Second inning, 1-0 Dodgers. Now back, 1-1. Hershiser at first. Brock at second. Two out. If you remember in Hershiser's game, after the game, he was so pumped up. He talked about running around the base paths in the third inning to burn up the excess adrenaline, and it calmed him down. He doesn't seem to be hyped at all in his first two innings of pitching today. That's his run. 1-2. Brock at second, Hershiser at first. Two away.
Fastball hit into center field.
a good pitch. Outside part of the plate, and he just serves it. It was not right down the middle. One ball and two strikes. Could be he was trying to sink one, and Duncan just served it.
Landreau, the on-deck hitter, almost hit him with the bat trying to get over and signal to Brock that he didn't have to slide. By the way, he didn't exactly pussyfoot that ball up to the plate. That was a 92-mile-an-hour fastball. Here's Landreau, who took him to deep left center in the first inning. Pickoff play, and Hershiser just got back. He hesitated and still got back.
Andujar hesitated, and he lost the play. They had him. They had Hershiser picked off right here. He's going the wrong way. He really doesn't know what to do here. And look at Ozzie hollering, give me the ball. But Andujar waited until Ozzie got to the bag. Had he thrown it when Ozzie was on the move, he would have had him because Hershiser was really dancing the wrong way.
Hershiser at second, Duncan at first, two out. 0-1. The Dodgers two runs, four hits. The Cardinals no runs, two hits, and we are just warming up, literally and figuratively. Temperature in the middle 80s here in Los Angeles. And Kenny hits a high fly ball to right center. It's playable, says McGee. So the Dodgers get one run on a walk and two hits, lead 2-0. And we'll be back after these messages from your local station.
Friday on Miami Vice. Can Crockett and Tubbs rely on a crazy ex-cop?
Or would you rather go for what's behind door number three?
Friday on Miami Vice.
You know what I like about St. Louis?
Everything, man. White people and really, I love me.
It's hard to be humble if you live in St. Louis.
I like St. Louis.
It's a major league city.
Legends like Stan the Man.
Heroes like Lou.
World's greatest fans.
They're going to do it. Everyone here in the bleachers know it.
St. Louis number one.
Cardinals.
The Cards.
We'll show you St. Louis.
Show me the Cards, Spy.
A winning team.
Sometimes a simple river crossing isn't so simple. And when you've got him back, it's your turn. Head for the beer brewed natural as a mountain stream, for a taste as smooth as its name. Head for the beer. Head for the mountains.
Week after week, you can't afford to shop anywhere else but Kroger. Stock up this week with cost-cutter savings on your favorite national brands. Save on Pup's facial tissues, just $1.09 for the 250-count box.
Wow!
Bounty, the quick picker-upper, is cost-cutter priced at 75 cents a roll.
Ooh!
Keep baby dryer with the convenience pack of new Blue Ribbon Pampers, only $8.99.
Ah!
Cost-cutter savings do make the difference. Go Krogering!
Are computers invading your privacy? We'll show you tonight at 10.
Game 6 of the National League Championship Series is brought to you by Century 21 Real Estate Organization and by Ralston Purina Company, makers of Purina Pet Foods and other fine products from Checkerboard Square. It is hard to believe, as we see that shot of Dodger Stadium, a rather serene scene it would appear. It is hard to believe of all the drama taking place down on the field, and also not too far away. The fire departments of Southern California trying to put the lid on hell, as one of the headlines recorded today. And we go on.
Watch Porter's reaction on that base hit by Hershiser. He pounds the glove and he just turns his back on and says, I can't watch any more of this. I know the feeling. Many, many times it just happens. It is just pure disgust. Nothing you can do. You're not upsetting anybody. It's just that you're just going to react.
Here's Andujar now to start it off against Hershiser. Andujar probably drives it to left field. Back goes Guerrero to the track at the wall. Can't get it. And into second base goes Andujar with a double, and Guerrero has hurt himself. Guerrero is limping in left field. Yeah.
and he might have hit that arm again.
Might be that arm. Watch the way he hits it. He doesn't think that ball's hit that hard. And the horn batting practice hit three balls in the seats. Watch Guerrero now. He goes into the wall very hard. It's that bad hand first.
Yep.
And here goes Bill Buehler out there to see what how he's feeling. He is hurting.
Remember, he also has a bad knee, but I think he re-injured the wrist. And the way he talked to Landro and looked up, I think the sun bothered him. I think he feels he might have caught the ball, but the sun got him.
Andujar hit the first pitch, but I asked him if he was going to bat right-handed or left-handed. He said right-handed. I asked him why. He said because he didn't want his pitching arm exposed. There's a shot of it again. Now look at the left hand, the glove hand, go into the wall, and that's the bad hand. And you can see him coming off, and he's in pain. It's the pain that forced him to limp. In fact, when he throws the ball, watch, he almost just flings it in there.
So Bill Buehler working on that left wrist, which he originally injured on the 7th of September, going after a foul ball on a Game of the Week Saturday afternoon telecast with the New York Mets. So for Guerrero, struggling at best anyway, that's all he needed to do was re-injure it. And he's just going to try and fight it off. There is the proof of that bad right knee that he has had. He's really a fellow with a lot of problems out there in left field.
And it's strange. It always seems when you have an injury, no matter what you do, you can't hide it.
You know, it's interesting, too, about fate and how you can't plan. Vince Coleman gets hurt, and they play Tito Landrum. And who knows, maybe Coleman would have had a good night. But all we do know is Landrum had four hits. And then, the day before yesterday, Ozzie Smith is hitting in the number two slot. Normally, against Valenzuela in the first game, Ozzie was batting eighth. But in the number two slot, that meant he came up against Needham Fuhr and won the game with a home run. Well, here is Willie McGee. With Andujar at second, nobody out in the third inning. Interesting, the first ball hit in the air was hit right-handed by Joaquin Andujar, who is always tough to figure out. McGee grounded to short in the first inning. Matlock has shortened up on the grass. McGee hitting 182, the Dodgers hoping Andujar had missed first, but Dick Stello said no. So Hershiser is not fooling people. He's allowed three hits plus a brilliant play by Duncan. 1-0. McGee followed by Ozzie Smith. And that's hit up the middle, speared by Duncan to get him. And I'm not sure whether Hershiser's foot touched that ball or not. But Duncan was able to handle it. Maybe it just hit the side of the mound, and that took a little smoke away from it.
That and the fact that he kind of hit it on the handle, but he roams wide and very far. He's on the first base side of second. As you can see, and put something on that throw and gets McGee. He may have broken his bat on that. We'll see it here. It's off the side of the mound. He tried to kick it. Duncan is really showing some great defense out there.
And remember, he's a fellow who could not play the first game in St. Louis because of the spike left knee and the foul ball on the instep. The Dodger infield is back except for Matlock. Everybody else goes back. Ozzie Smith, the batter. And remember, he bunted. And Hershiser unable to pick it up. It went for a single. Ozzie has hit in all six league championship games. Right. And of course, in this spot, he is an ideal hitter because he just doesn't strike out. Standing at third, Joaquin Andujar. One out, third inning. The Dodgers, two runs, four hits. Cardinals, no runs, three hits. Game six.
Looked like, I'm sure, Hershiser just wanted some reassurance. He wanted to hear it as to where they're going to pitch and what they're going to use. What do you want me to throw? Fastball down. That kind of thing.
0-1. Now back. So now you really have the battle. Hershiser has far as being a strikeout pitcher, the most strikeouts he has had in a game this year, he had 9 in May against Philadelphia. But he is not really the kind of man you expect to blow a hitter away. And you have the real challenge now with Ozzie Smith, 0-2 and a runner at third. Ozzie, you can bet with that short stroke, just trying to get the ball on the ground and pick up Andujar. And Socha talking to the infielder.
He mentioned it to Brock. Come in a couple steps and we can get the guy at the plate. They've moved Brock in. Sachs's back, but Brock has moved in a little bit.
Ozzie asking for time. So Madlock at the corner. Sachs is deep, and Brock has come up two steps.
Like all ball players, he just moved back those two steps.
Landreau shaded to left center, and Guerrero is very shallow in left field. They've really brought him up. So one out, Andujar at third, 0-2 to Ozzie. And there's a miracle to strike out the Wizards.
There was a breaking ball, heartbreaking ball inside, and it was off the strike zone. Ozzie trying to knock that run in, chased it. You'll see it. Great pitch by Hershiser, way ahead. Even if Ozzie hits it, he hits it on a handle, really doesn't send it anywhere.
Give you an idea of how difficult it is to get Ozzie Smith. You know how many times he struck out this year? 27 in over 600 at-bats. That's near miraculous. Now here's Tommy Herr, hit into a fourth play in the first inning. Ball one. So Andujar is at third, and a big RBI man at the plate. And he is very much on his stick, as you can see. Herr with four doubles, a home run, and five RBIs. Here's Andujar, 90 feet away. One ball and no strikes to Tommy Herr. Ball two. After Herr, Jack Clark.
So many ways to measure a pitcher, but the best way is we look at Clark is what does he do with a man on third and less than two outs? And when he knows a given situation, can he execute in this particular spot? He needed the strikeout from Ozzie Smith. Hershiser went out and got it.
2-0 to count to Tommy Herr. 2-0 Dodgers, top of the third.
Has turned him loose, so you can't take for granted that he'll be taken so that they can get Clark up there. He's been given the green light.
And of course, Lasorda sweating out the prospect of Jack Clark representing the go-ahead run coming up. 3-0 to Tommy Herr. In there. Whitey Herzog down 2-0 here in the top of the third. Andujar waiting to be picked up with two out. 3-1 to Herr. Fouled away. 3-2. Here in the inning, Andujar not only doubled, but again, you have to remember that we feel Guerrero re-injured that left wrist. So it's questionable just how long can he play, how well can he swing the bat. Two outs later, Andujar is at third, but the Dodgers greatly concerned over their man in left field, whom they are calling way up. That's Amalfitano calling him up.
They're moving him over to left center field. They want him to move over.
3-2 to Tommy Herr. Two out, third inning, Andujar at third. 2-0 Dodgers. Line drive, base hit, and the run is in, just like that. So you let Andujar double, and immediately the Cardinals, like the good ball club they are, cash him in.
Did you ever see a ball player, as I'm sure you have, but in recent times, do so much and be so matter-of-fact and quiet about it as Tommy Herr?
What a year.
He just goes out and does the job as you look at that Cardinal bench. No fanfare, takes his batting practice, goes out and fields his ground balls, drives in runs. Just gets the job done. You wind him up and send him out, he gives you a good game.
And he has hit in all six of the league championship games as well as fielding his position flawlessly. driving in clutch runs. For Tommy Herb, he has knocked in a half a dozen runs now in the six games. This year he had 110 RBIs. He indeed is an all-star. And now here's Jack Clark, hit into a force play in the first inning. And another thing that Herb does, he does everything well, he runs well. He has stolen 31 bases. And he has stolen second base 26 out of 28, although he's doubtful with a hitter like Clark at the plate. Right.
It's a cinch if he runs. Sax will have to cover as we look at Rhett Shandies.
Rhett Shandies, if the Dodgers win today and it makes it a seven-game series, it certainly would not be any surprise to him. We'll conclude the thought in a minute as to why. 0-1 to Jack Clark. 1-1. Rhett Shandies has been in seven best-of-seven World Series. Three as a player, two as a manager, two as a coach. All seven went seven. 1-1 to count to Clark. Dodgers, top of the third. Tommy Herr standing at first.
Good point, Storm 1. You read, he had all his brothers. Boy, was that a night scores nightmare. Five Shandies and Garagiola. That got me writing for 2-3 hours.
Box score. 1-1 to Clark.
And they got Herr picked off. And a high throw allowed him to get back. He's calling balk. He thought he balked. He made a move, and he wants to know why they didn't call it a balk. Stelos, he's arguing. He thought he had balked. He had stopped, but he completed the throw. Right here, he's surprised. Now, he's got him right here. Now, why it would be a balk? He's off the mound. Everything's fine to me.
The mistake that Hershiser made was to make that extra step. If he had just thrown the ball over to first, they got him. But he made a step and then threw, and it was too late. It gave her the step to get back to the bag.
He thought he'd get him at second.
We'll see how important that is now in a 2-1 ball game. You miss the third out on a pickoff play at first, and you have a home run hitter at the plate.
Mike's just trying to break the mood now, because I'm sure Hershiser's thinking about it. Hey, come on, let's get this hitter now. You can't afford to worry about her. You got to think about him, sure, but you make a mistake on Clark, and we're not going to have that lead.
And, you know, it could have been Hershiser gathering a little wool. He had gotten a base hit in the second inning and then walked up, and before you know it, Andujar took him to the left field wall for a double, and he's got to shake himself here, or Clark will do the shaking. 2-1. Two out, 2-1 Dodgers, top of the third. And he hits a fly ball off the hands. Tough play. Guerrero can't get it. He hit it off the hands, and although we can hear it near home plate, the outfield is canned, and instinctively they're frozen. You don't play the outfield by the crack of the bat.
If you do, you miss the play, and you go by the swing, and Clark takes that big swing. Guerrero picked it up right away. It's just that he hit it on a handle, and there was nothing you could do but watch it drop.
I remember a quote which certainly applies here on that one. The luck of having talent is not enough. One must also have a talent for luck. And for the Cardinals, they have Herb picked off, and he gets back. Now a little flare into left field, and they're in business. Here's Andy Van Slyke, grounded out in the second inning. Strike. Here in the inning, Andujar doubled, McGee grounded him to third, and Smith struck out. But then Herr singled on a 3-2 pitch for a run. Clark is jammed and fights it off, and a little blooper into left field for a base hit. 1-1. On deck, Terry Pendleton.
They expect Van Slyke to pull the ball. He's got some room in left center field. Landro shades him towards right center field. Deep, Marshall's deep in right field. There you see the defense. Infield is swung over. There's the room, left center field.
That double by Andujar, you can't stress it more as far as the fact it took the initiative away from the Dodgers. That's fouled away. This place was all pumped up. It was 2-0 Dodgers, two innings. And then Andujar walked up and hit one over Guerrero's head. Guerrero hurt his wrist, and it's been kind of downhill, and they've lost the edge. So he's a key man in this game, more ways than one.
Whenever a pitcher gets a hit, it affects everybody. You saw when Hershiser got the hit, Whitey got his bullpen gone. You know, there are very few pitchers that are good enough hitters, and when they get a hit, you expect it. Most of the time, shock sets in.
1-2 the count. Hurt second, Jack Clark at first, two out. 2-2. Of course, Van Slyke, a left-hand batter. It's a generalization, of course, but most left-hand hitters like the ball down, and most right-hand hitters like the ball up. Well, Hershiser is primarily a sinker ball pitcher. He wants a ground ball. But if he pitches low to Van Slyke, it's power against power. Well, this is a big moment. Second, Clark at first, two out. Fouled away.
There are two schools of thought on that, man. A lot of guys say, well, you try to pitch his weakness. Oh, no, he's got to go to my strength. If I'm catching that ball game, he's got to beat my pitcher's strength. I'm not going to worry about his weakness in a spot like this.
And Hershiser so far has had seven ground balls. Plus that long double hit over the head of Pedro Guerrero. And he has struck out one. 2-1 Dodgers, third inning. High fly ball into left center. Guerrero and Landro both calling. It'll be Guerrero. And Guerrero is due to lead off the bottom of the third. Get an indication of how badly he hurt his wrist. At the end of 2.5, 2-1 Dodgers.
Have you driven a Ford?
Ford dealers present 8.8 Plus. 8.8 annual percentage rate financing on 86 and 85 Tempo and Escort, both when equipped with manual transmissions, plus tough new 86 Rangers and sporty 86 Bronco 2s, plus a special lease offer on all 86 and 85 Ford cars and light trucks. 1986 is off to a great start with 8.8 Plus at Ford dealers now.
Building a tub starts with an oil-resistant sole bonded to a durable Goodyear weld. Then full grain leather rubbers are double and triple stitched together for strength and fully insulated for warmth. Add a pillow-cushioned insole and a padded collar for comfort. Here's Texas Steel, on sale at Kmart, just $25. Similar styles available in wide widths. Now Texas Steel's an even better buy. You can't do better than Kmart, the saving place.
Zero in on breakfast cereal and you'll find Sunflakes, the cereal with zero added sugar. You know, many other cereals are loaded with sugar, up to 55%. But Sunflakes doesn't use added sugar to taste delicious. Sunflakes are sweetened 100% with NutraSweet. So you get a light, sweet taste and a cereal you can really feel good about. So zero in on the taste of Sunflakes. Now that you know the score.
America's favorite pastime returns to NBC as the nation's top rollers battle it out for Bowler of the Year honors. Join Jay Randolph and Bowler of the Decade Earl Anthony for the premiere of the PBA Fall Tour, November 2nd on NBC.
Bottom of the third inning with the Dodgers leading the Cardinals 2-1. Two runs, four hits, and no errors for the Dodgers. One run, five hits, no errors for the Cardinals. The Cardinals leaving men aboard. They have left four, and the Dodgers have left three. So each side with ample opportunity to open it up a little bit.
Underscore what you've been saying. Guerrero is not even on the on-deck circle. He'll come out, but he was there, and a lot of the guys talking to him, and here he comes now. It'll be an interesting time at bat, man.
He has assumed such tremendous proportions because of the way he carried the Dodgers in June and July. He really became the big man, the big guy, the MVP, until the injury. And from September the 7th on, he has just been shrinking, although his stature on the ball club remains the same. He is not close to being the same hitter. His average in the league championship series, 278. But I think he made a mistake. It is only my own personal thought. You see that note? He wanted to break that record so badly that he played every day with the bad wrist, where he should have rested it. Played every day, and I think developed some bad habits in trying to hit a home run in otherwise meaningless games. So he has not been the same hitter in the league championship series. Right. And we'll see how he swings the bat now, having twisted that wrist again.
Man, it certainly is understandable, though, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Good. Yeah.
And he was very honest about it. He said, I want to break that record more than anything. One and one.
You know, when you talk about a team leader, a guy does it with the bat and with the glove. I mean, the most overrated thing ever in baseball, as far as I was concerned, was the holler guy. The guy that hollered two outs when you got $1 million scoreboard would tell you the same thing, and then there'd be a bunt play, and that same guy would get locked jaw.
One and one. Popped it up. It'll be Terry Pendleton. And look out as he almost has a collision with John McSherry, and that would have registered about a 7 on the Richter scale.
That's a high, high sky. Now, he flipped the glasses and lost the ball. Watch him flip the glasses up so he can see it better. He's looking for the base there. He sees he's got plenty of room. He's in foul territory. There go the glasses. That high sky, remember, it was Nobby Cuano gave me the best explanation. And then you almost see that collision between Pendleton and the handball court. You don't know if the ball's going up or coming down, and that's why it makes it so high. Oh, John got out of the way, though. Give him credit for that. He was
sure
right
did.
On top of the play, but, man, he is a big guy.
It was a good play by John. He was able to get out of Pendleton's way on a ball that certainly fooled Terry. So one out, and here is Madlock. First ball swinging, singled in the first inning. Breaking ball strike in the count 0-1.
Man, there's not a cloud in the sky.
Nope.
I mean, nothing is up there. Just a blimp in a plane.
0-1 the count. Breaking ball strike. Unfortunately, if you today, it's deceptive. That is just some of the smoke from the raging inferno that is a part of Southern California. So the blue skies over the ballpark are fine, but the mountains have disappeared. And Madlock strikes out.
There's that sidearm pitch. It's vicious. He did it to Madlock in the game he pitched here, and Madlock didn't give him a chance the first time up when he tried to get ahead of him. He jumped on the first pitch here with the sidearm curveball. He got him. Watch this. He really drops it down, and it looks like it's even out of the strike zone. It certainly is.
And as each minute goes by, I keep thinking of how important that Andujar double was. It looked for a while there as if the Dodgers had everything going their way, and boy, they were brought to an abrupt halt. Andujar's double and the resulting run. There's a drive to left field, but it's playable, and Landrum will make the play. So the Dodgers are out in order to show you how things have calmed down for Andujar. And at the end of 3, Dodgers 2, Cardinals 1.
Here's you. Here's your competition. One of you will call AT&T Small Business Experts. One of you won't. One of you will find out how to use long distance
to cover your customer base.
To beat your competition. So who's going to call? You or the other guy? AT&T Long Distance Services. Talk with us. AT&T, the right choice.
He's not a national hero, but every year, thousands of people turn to him for protection. He's an independent insurance agent who rides with the Kemper Cavalry. He knows insurance. His job is to scout out the best values for your auto, home, life, health, or business. And when the chips are down, he's a good man to have on your side. Once you compare Kemper, you'll ride with us.
Lots of hustle, that's our repeat. That's why he's eating what the big boys eat. Loved his Wheaties since he was small. Now dig in, big boy, have a ball. Classic hit of crunchy wheat. Pure and simple, not too sweet. Dive right into those Wheaties' feet. Now go tell your mama what the big boys eat.
Sun
Sunday, Barbara Eden is back as Jeannie, and you'll be rolling in the aisles when she cuts loose.
It's mass hysteria.
I Dream of Jeannie, 15 years later, Sunday.
Three innings in here at Dodger Stadium with the Dodgers battling to stay afloat. Two runs, four hits, and no errors. And the Cardinals, one run, five hits, and no errors. Dodger Stadium, a magnificent ballpark, and all you have to do is look at its history. It opened in 1962. 21 times they have played to over 2 million in paid attendance. Six times they have played to over 3 million. In 1982, the paid attendance, 3,608,881, an all-time record and out of sight as far as everybody else in baseball.
And it sure was great, Vin, to see Johnny Podres and Roy Campanella. They threw out the first ball today. Memories really got jarred.
Of 1955. Pendleton fouls it away in the count 0-1. In talking about the attendance at Dodger Stadium, the old story, whenever you see a successful business, someone once made a courageous decision, and that somebody, Walter O'Malley. Check swing, they're going to look at third. Swing, says John McSherry. And the count is 0-2.
And I dare you to go argue with him. Here's the swing by Pendleton. What do you think?
I think sure.
I think John was dead right.
0-2, the count of Terry Pendleton, then Darryl Porter and Tito Landrum. 1-2. Pendleton robbed of a hit in the second inning as Mariano Duncan backhanded his ball on the grass in shallow left field and threw him out. 1-2. Little Nubber back to Hershiser, and he handles the comebacker to Brock. Here's that play that deprived Pendleton. Take a look at it. Remember, Pendleton is hitting left-handed. That makes it even tougher from where Duncan has to throw.
He really had to throw that ball hard. If you've ever wondered about umpires, do they get scouting reports or do they make up their own reports when a pitcher, like, say, Jerry Crawford behind the plate, does he say Hershiser's going to throw curveball, fastballs? I asked Bruce Fleming just to reconfirm it. He says, we just categorize it as, does he throw strikes or is he wild? And both these pitchers today throw strikes.
Here's Darryl Porter, ball one.
See, now my thought would be, one would say the other, does this guy complain a lot?
That's one thing they really don't worry about.
2-0 to Darryl Porter, to single to center with two out in the second inning. On deck, waiting his turn, Tito Landrum. 2-0 to Porter, hitting 250. And he fly balls to right center, and Landrum is there. He hit that on the hands.
Just watching that last pitch, though, and Jerry Crawford behind the plate, I wonder why his dad, Shag Crawford, doesn't get on him a little bit about why don't you umpire like I did and get behind that catcher. Jerry doesn't use the catcher. His father used the catcher better than anybody I know. Foul balls didn't get old Shag because he was using that catcher, and that's a smart umpire.
Here's Tito Landrum. Not to keep throwing quotes, except great minds, and they're always worth listening to. Ground ball to the hole to Duncan. Boy, that hugged the ground, and he gets him. Mark Twain said, I always thought my father was an idiot when I was 14. And when I was 21, I was amazed how smart he had gotten in the last 7 years.
Ever since man invented machines to move people, he has sought new ways to defeat the wind's resistance. And now there's a totally new aerodynamic design for this age. Ford brings you the age of Aerostar. Aerostar, it's easy to get in. Easy to drive, easy to stretch out in, easy to handle, easy to park. Aerostar, it just makes life a little easier.
Aerostar,
Ford Aerostar.
Don't you just love that alley cat?
He's awesome.
Don't you just love that alley cat?
Nobody's
talk
Alley Cat brand cat food.
Don't you just love that Alley Cat?
Just good cat food.
On this side, I can feel a tingling sensation. And this side, there's not much happening.
Look what you use.
Denerix.
Unlike Head & Shoulders, Denerix adds an extra anti-itch medicine and conditioner, too.
Goodbye, Head & Shoulders. Hello, Denerix.
Bill Evans can't breathe. Will you try Dristan long-lasting nasal spray?
I'll try anything.
Can you breathe now?
Yeah, I think so.
Prove it. Prove it to yourself. Dristan goes to work in seconds, lasts all day.
NFL plays here, America.
First, the silver and black attack runs into the bruising defense of Cleveland as the Raiders battle the Browns. Then, Seattle soars into a mile-high stampede when the Seahawks go eye-to-eye with the Broncos.
The NFL plays here on NBC. The action starts with NFL 85.
Bottom of the fourth inning, 2-1 Dodgers. Once again, we'd like to remind our viewers we'll be selecting the NBC light beer from Miller Player of the Game at the conclusion of this ball game. So we're just starting. Bottom of the fourth, the Dodgers will have Mike Socia, followed by Greg Brock, and then Steve Sachs. 2-1 Dodgers. If you join us a little late, Duncan doubled in the first inning, and with two out, Madlock singled him home. In the second inning, Brock Ward took second on a single by Hershiser, and Duncan's single got Brock home. For the Cardinals, Andujar opened up the third with a double, and with two out, Tommy Herr singled him home. So it is 2-1 Dodgers, fourth inning. And Mike Socia grounded out in the second inning. In the series, hitting .214. He has not been hitting the ball crisply at all, however. One of his hits in the series was a bunt. Strike. He got a broken bat single against Ford. So he has three hits, one a broken bat single and one a bunt. And I think he's paying the price for catching every day.
So we shall put that under the heading of a little knowledge is a dangerous thing, right?
It always happens.
So that'll bring up Greg Brock. Brock walked. The count went to 3-0, and you were pretty sure he was going to rip 3-0 if he got a strike, but the pitch was way high and outside. And you certainly don't look bunt, especially with Socia the runner and Brock the batter. He has two career sacrifices in almost 1,200 at-bats.
And a strictly pull hitter. He's got that gap between first and second.
Well, there must be something in the wind. Socia taking a bigger lead than he should. And Clark grumbling, he thought he had him.
Andujar has a good move. He unloads it in a hurry. It really is not that big a lead.
Just tardy and getting back on a good move.
And you notice that foot where it went in really went in the side of the bag.
High fly ball into right center. McGee going back to the track and will make the catch. So Brock flies to center and Socia holding at first, one away.
Now they'll look out.
I tell you, there is a dramatic difference. And it's the architecture of the two ballparks, Busch Stadium in St. Louis and Dodger Stadium. Acoustically, almost anything sounds like a cannon shot in Busch Stadium. But since Dodger Stadium is not really completely enclosed, you don't really get that same sound at all. Sacks fly to right in the second inning, ball one. Dodgers two, Cardinals one in the fourth. Joaquin Andujar, a 21-game winner against Oral Hershiser, who won 19. Time. Two birds flew high overhead, and the shadow of the birds went right across home plate. And Sachs jumped out of there. Birdies are okay in golf, but not now.
Porter looking for some help from the bench. They call pitch outs from there.
On deck. Sachs is not much of a bunter. base hit. Strike. One and one. Each side with five hits. Each side retired in order just once. Half swing, check it first. No swing, says Dick Stello. Two balls, one strike.
Here it is, take a look.
Disciplined hitter by any means. The only thing you can say about that swing was at least he hit it. So you have a runner at second, two out, and here is Hershiser. On the 3-2 pitch the other day when Sack struck out, he struck out at ball four. He's a tough man to put a play on. Hershiser singled to right in the second inning. He's 2-for-5 in the series. Ball one. Remember, he bounced a single to left in the first game against Andujar, and the single to right today.
I don't know if I just saw it or it was in my mind, but it looked like he was walking up on that pitch. He got set in the batter's box, and they kept creeping up like he won the ball inside.
Looking breaking ball. Breaking ball hit down to Terry Fenelon. That's that, but he's out of the way, and they will begin the next inning with Duncan. No runs, one hit. And at the end of four, 2-1 Dodgers. We'll be back after these messages from your local station.
Friday on Knight Rider, a hostage crisis leads Michael into a one-man war.
Let's give these guys a run for the money.
Against an army of terrorists. Friday on Knight Rider.
Behind this or any other Missouri license plate is access to more private information than you can imagine. Information that can reveal much about you and your family. Information you may want protected.
It's like Big Brother, because there ain't nothing that's private anymore.
How easy is it for your private life to become public knowledge? On Cover Story, Rick Edlund will show you. No secrets, tonight at 10 on Channel 5, Eyewitness News Nightbeat.
Week after week, you can't afford to shop anywhere else but Kroger. Save on your favorite national brands like Bounty Towels, the Quick Picker Upper, just 75 cents a roll.
Wow.
Reduce static cling in every wash load with Bounce Fabric Softener Sheets. The 40-count box is cost-cutter priced at $1.79.
Ooh.
And save on the mildness of Ivory Soap. The 4-pack is on sale for just 89 cents.
Ah.
Cost-cutter savings do make the difference. Go Krogering.
Just when things are easing down, trouble starts up.
Ah!
And when the dust and everything else is settled, you head for the mountains.
Bush.
Head for the beer brewed natural as a mountain stream, for a taste as smooth as its name.
Bush.
Head for Bush Beer.
Head for the mountains.
Mike Bush and the Bush Leaguer tonight on Eyewitness News Nightbeat.
Game 6 of the National League Championship Series is brought to you by Ralston Purina Company, makers of Purina pet foods and other fine products from Checkerboard Square. And by Ford and your local Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? I think there have been a couple of keys so far in four innings. Andujar's double in the third inning seemed to take away some of the Dodger momentum and wake up the Cardinals. And a key pitch, Sack swinging at what should have been ball four in the fourth inning. And instead of giving the Dodgers first and second and one out and Hershiser to do whatever, Sack's grounded out, so did Hershiser, and that went by. Plus the double that shook Guerrero up when he went into the fence in left field. All of that in the first four innings.
Bet you nickel the first pitch to Andujar is a curveball.
Hitting off for St. Louis.
You mean after what happened last time.
That's right. He laid a fastball in there and Andujar really hit it. Let's see what it is. I know that's what I'd be calling for.
So Andujar one for one.
Whoop. Uncle Charlie, hello there.
Joaquin, one for one today. 333 in the series. Ball two. There wasn't much on that. That was an off-speed pitch.
He didn't snap that one off at all. No, he's got to come in with the fastball. And Andujar, he's got pretty good power. That ball happens to be where his bat is when he swings. He can hit it out of here. He had three of them out in batting practice.
Two balls, no strikes. Ball three.
That's something I can never understand. A pitcher uses the same ball, throws three bad ones, and then changes it. Nobody's touched it. It got dirty between pitcher and catcher.
Yeah. His first game, which happened to be game two of the series, he hit into a double play and he struck out. When he hit into a double play, he bunted. But remember, as we showed you, it wasn't a case of not running it out. He was on his back. 3-1. Busted bat or lost bat? Busted bat. Foul ball. Boy, a big chunk. Woof. 3-2.
He had the handle in his hand, and you could see, watch his bat just splinter. He's got a big hunk of it left in his hand. And there it goes flying over Madlock's head. Bill
he
had it all
move.
Away. He had it all away. I've always wanted an infielder to pick up the bat and see if he could throw it across the infield, make it like a ground ball.
Worst I ever saw in my life, two things. Larry Jackson of the Cardinals pitching in Vero Beach, and a bat broken just like that,
mm-hmm.
went back like a propeller blade and went right through his cheek,
mm-hmm.
knocked out teeth. And the other one was Steve Yeager getting pierced in the on-deck circle. Same thing, got him in the neck. That dangerous. 3-2 to Andujar. A hot one, one hopper right at Madlock.
He was hustling down that line, too. He was really running hard. He thought he had himself a base hit, but Madlock made a good play. It was right at him.
Right at his belt buckle.
Nothing he could do but catch that ball. He didn't have to hardly move. Look at that.
Maybe a little lower than the belt buckle.
He was sure in front of it.
So one away in the fifth inning. Dodgers leading 2-1, and here is Willie McGee. Twice grounded to short. McGee hitting 174. A dramatic difference, of course, from the magnificent season he enjoyed.
There's a lot of things you have to like about this young man besides his baseball ability. Most guys would be complaining. He says, I'm just not swinging at strikes. It's my fault. End of story.
1-0 to Willie. Way outside. Now remember, Hershiser was 3-0 to Andujar, and Socia doesn't like him going 2-0 to McGee. He's going out there to kind of
pump him up a little bit.
He also saw something in his delivery because he motioned to him that come like three quarters. Like he saw something in the mechanics of Hershiser that he didn't like.
Position of the arm.
Yeah, right.
Two balls and no strikes. Lasorda with his pitching coach, Ron Peronoski. For them, this is it. It's do or die. For the Cardinals, they have the luxury that they could lose and still be in the hunt tomorrow. 2-1, the count to Willie McGee. One out, fifth inning, Dodgers 2, Cardinals 1. And he's behind 3-1, dangerous way to pitch. Fell behind Andujar and got him, but Andujar almost broke the ball. And now he goes 3-1 to McGee with Ozzy on deck. Duncan to get under it, and of course with Madlock in on the grass, he couldn't go back and get it.
There are statistics that prove just how bad it is to keep pitching from behind like Hershiser is, but I can't help but almost paraphrase our good friend Lee Trevino. Golfers who chip for pars and dogs that chase cars don't last long. You can put pitchers who pitch behind in the same category.
And how? One away in the fifth inning. The Dodgers 2 runs, 5 hits. Cardinals 1 run, 5 hits. Cardinals have left 4. The Dodgers have left 4.
Hershiser must have pretty good stuff, though. Man, he's breaking bats. He just got McGee, he got Andujar, he got Clark.
And with a second hitter in a row, 3-2. Hit to left field. So McGee, a rabbit, is at first. Remember, 56 stolen bases during the regular season. And with one out, Ozzie Smith the batter. So the tying run is aboard and in very capable hands or feet.
You gotta believe something's gonna happen.
Hershiser has allowed a half a dozen hits. He allowed 8 hits in his winning game in 9 innings. Of those hits were in the early going. He allowed 8 hits, and 6 of the 8 hits came in the first 4 innings. So now he has allowed 6 hits in 4 1/3 innings. He settled down the last time. We'll see what happens this time. The Cardinals grounded into the fewest double plays of any team in the league, although he hit into 13. Madlock shortens up at third, and they're watching McGee. And 52 of them stealing second.
That usually tells you there's no pitch out on, but obviously he's pretty much concerned.
McGee drawing a line like a businessman's bottom line. Yep. One ball and no strike, so he has been behind on all 3 hitters. A dangerous trend for Hershiser.
Malfitano is the man on the bench who calls the pitch outs, and so should constantly looking at that bench for some help.
It looks easy playing first base and having the pitcher throw over there. But the first baseman is also looking behind the pitcher into that shirt sleeve crowd. And of course, there was a famous play here in the 63 World Series involving Joe Pepitone, who lost a throw. So it is a lot more difficult than it might assume just to throw as if they're playing catch.
And the pitcher's throw varies a lot of times. Harder, softer. He wants to throw the same way, but it depends.
out of top of the ball and beat it down into the dirt. And he's checking with Hal Lanier.
He's acting it out well as we look at Lanier. Socia is observing all this. So is Amalfitano. There's a lot of cat and mouse going on right now.
Enough to where Brock could at least make the tag. Here's one that's kind of high. He just catches and puts it on him.
One ball, one strike. Ball two. So far, with Ozzie Smith at the plate, Oral Hershiser has thrown over to first 10 times, and he's made three pitches. Now, he made six pitches to
where he catches that ball that goes right into it. I mean, he guns it.
I can see, too, on that play, and only from that shot, where the Dodgers have worked with Socia. He used to long-arm the ball, and on that, it was very evident how his elbow had broken, and he caught the ball close to his body.
He caught it close to him, which is what we talked about the first time.
Right.
If you catch the ball out here, you have to bring it back to your body and then bring the arm up. He caught it close to his body, much like a bow and arrow effect is what it is. He got that arm right up behind his ear, and he really gunned it.
Well, it shows you an awful lot of hard work went into that throw to get Willie McGee. 3-2, the count to Ozzie. Ground ball to Duncan. And they're out of the inning. Handshakes all around. Four and a half, 2-1 Dodgers.
When you start something good, everyone wants a piece of it. Take light beer from Miller. Now there's lots of light beers out there saying they're less filling. Heck, that was the easy part. The hard part is brewing a light beer that tastes great. That's why Light's always brewed only with the finest ingredients. To let all that great beer taste come through for guys like you and me. The taste that's made light beer for Miller, America's favorite light beer.
Hey, I always thought it was easy opening cans.
That cool, refreshing feeling of Wrigley's Spearmint Gum puts a sparkle in your eye, a spring in your step, and makes things lots of fun.
It's that Miller, the Wrigley's Spearmint Gum. It's that Miller.
That clean, fresh taste Wrigley's Spearmint's got. That little lift that means a lot.
It's that little lift from Wrigley's Spearmint
gum. A nice walk with my best friend. What more could a dog want? The ultimate biscuit? Nice, but we'd rather have original jerky treats. How about some of our favorite Playmates? Nah, we'd rather have jerky treats. All right, jerky treats. What a friend.
More dogs would rather have the real meat taste of original jerky treats than just about anything.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking, but believe me, nothing beats jerky treats.
Hi, I'm Bob Costas, former utility infielder for the Toledo Mudhens and pitching coach for the 1962 Mets. Hope you're enjoying NBC's exclusive coverage of the League Championship Series. And I'd like to invite you to join me and the rest of my crack staff, the Axe, Ahmad Rashad, and Larry King, for the first word in pro football, NFL 85, Sunday.
Nice and peaceful up there. And good and noisy down here.
That's Willie McGee after being thrown out at second base. He had a good jump, but you can see he really feels it, and he's thinking about that play.
McGee, of course, struggling in the series. He has been caught three times trying to steal while being successful only once. The league's leading hitter came in here hitting 190. So it's been a tough series for him.
But never an alibi.
Oh, no. Mariano Duncan doubled and singled. Then Landro and Guerrero. 2-1 Dodgers fifth inning. Scored a run in the first inning, singled to drive in a run in the second, and of course made a magnificent play on Pendleton. Following that, Daryl Porter got a base hit, so he has figured prominently in this one. And he put the tag on Willie McGee a moment ago. High chopper back to Andujar, who lost it in the sun.
In trouble from the minute the ball was hit. He looks up and he can't find it. Looking, trying to shade his eyes, and he really doesn't see it. What's the reaction of Andujar when the ball goes up? Now he can't find it, shades his eyes, still can't find it.
So Duncan gets aboard. They are going to give Andujar an error. Apparent that he had lost the ball in the sun, and the batter is Kenny Landro. Now remember, Duncan is a good base stealer. Landro does not bunt very much at all, and Landro is hitting 438. Duncan held on by Clark, and they'll watch him. He has stolen 14 straight. He finished up the year going 9 for 9.
He's one of those guys who sort of gives the green light to. If you get a good jump, take off. He's got a good lead.
He burned the Cardinals this year. He went 4 for 4 against them. Well, you know they're going to watch him. Remember now, he has a sore left knee where he was nicked. But he does not appear to be limping in any manner, shape, or form.
That'll slow you down, though, making him dive back into that bag like the Cardinals are doing.
Landro and time call because Duncan wasn't ready. And Landro is up there, and Duncan was just getting back on the bag, and he's saying, hey, que pasa, Chico? Wait a minute. So Landro walks about 30 feet away from home plate. He's up to say, excuse me. And that's as big a lead as he can take. If he takes a millimeter more, they'll hang him out to dry.
That was very close. Andujar unloads in a hurry. He has to dive back. When you're diving back like that, that is as far as you can go.
He went out to check his bottom line, as Willie McGee did. Backs out as if he's bothered a little bit. Perhaps his concentration. Now very slowly, Landro back into the box. And now time called again. Kenny doesn't appear ready. He looks slightly either confused or at least bothered.
Might be a play on. Got a sign.
For 16. And he has a look at Amalfitano as Andujar losing that bouncer in the sun as Duncan at first. And he bluffs. And so does Landro. And Andujar didn't bluff. He hit the deck. He wanted to give Porter a wide open shot at second base. Do you ever hit a pitcher?
Throw him? No.
Yeah. Uh-uh.
I've seen it happen, though, where they turn to watch the play. That was a good bluff by Mariano.
0-1 to count to Kenny Landro.
first base. It's a quick move.
He's pitching like a guy who won 21. Not giving you an inch. Working on Landreau and Duncan. Nobody out in the fifth. Dodgers 2, Cardinals 1. And there goes Duncan. The pitch is inside. The throw is high. I think a better throw might have gotten it. But Porter almost threw it into center field.
He threw it hard, but threw it high. Duncan, he's off and running. Straight steal. Look at that head looking for second base. A head first slide. And I mean, when he hits the dirt, he really picks up speed. It was a good ball for Porter to handle. Just too high.
And that was after six throws to first base. And Duncan now is 5 for 5 against the Cardinals this year. 1-1. Strike. I'm surprised Landreau even did that. He only sacrificed 3 times this year. The Dodgers are hoping he can get a ball that he can pull. Remember, in the first inning with Duncan at second, he took Andujar deep enough to left center so that Duncan could tag and get to third. 1-2. High bouncer over the mound behind second. Glad by Ozzie to get him. And over to third again, Duncan. And once more, we saw Ozzie Smith kickstart his body.
That's what he did. Watch him when he gets in the air. He's got to put something on it. Watch him shift it right there, and he gets enough on it. And again, Landreau does the thing that the good team does. They pick up the base with an out. He did it with the long fly ball in the second inning, or in the first inning, rather, and he picks it up here.
Well, now we're going to find out something. First of all, they're going to pitch to Guerrero. Secondly, remember, he re-injured his wrist. Thirdly, he has popped up to second with a runner at third and popped up to third. Andujar is going to pitch from a windup, and the infield is up. Breaking ball and a fly ball into left center. That'll be deep enough. McGee lost it for a moment. Makes the catch. Here comes Duncan, and he will score. So a chopper back to the mound that's lost in the sun is cashed in.
But he really doesn't give up. He throws it all away, hoping that maybe Duncan would stumble, maybe trip, fall, or something. And he got it to Porter all the way on the fly, but didn't have a chance.
Here's Madlock, single to drive in a run and struck out. 3-1 Dodgers in the fifth. First ball on a breaking ball, 0-1.
And twice, the two runs that the Dodgers have scored, Landreau was able to pick up that base with an out, and boom, they cashed it in.
Mariano Duncan is 2 for 3, scored twice, driven in one, and there's a high fly ball into deep left. Back goes Landreau, away back, it's gone.
Yesterday.
Then in the fourth inning, hit a two-run home run with that bad thumb. Now today has a single to drive in a run and a home run with that bad thumb. Bill Madlock, who became not Mad Dog, but Glad Dog, and has been quoted as saying, "I'm in heaven," must have found a miraculous cure for that left thumb.
I don't know of anything that'll cure aches and pains quicker than a base hit.
But what a base hit to take him 370, 375. And now here's Marshall hitting 190. Right. Interesting, and we pointed it out in his first game as Mike Marshall is ready to go against Andujar. You know, the Cardinals averaged 7 runs for Andujar in each game he won. Ground ball hit Dazzy. That will be that. But that was complicated by a comebacker lost in the sun. And at the end of 5, the Dodgers 4, the Cardinals 1. Herr, Clark, and Van Slyke, due up in the 6th.
Hey, John Edwards, you're treating that puppy like a dog. Robin Lynn, don't treat your puppy like a dog. Kit Miller, are you treating your puppy like a dog?
Oh, no. Dog food is for dogs. My puppy gets puppy food. Puppy Chow brand puppy food. I know puppies need more nutrition, and Purina Puppy Chow has it.
Good for you, Kit Miller.
No, good for him.
Don't treat your puppy like a dog, dog, dog. Give him Puppy Chow.
In both original and beef flavors.
When it's freezing cold and the sirens blow and the mercury's down to 20 below, you don't need problems, you gotta go. That's why America goes with Prestone.
A fresh fill of Prestone 2 antifreeze fights freeze-up and rust-up, too. A radiator could look this bad after just 10,000 miles of driving on weak, neglected antifreeze, while the Prestone radiator looks this good. Get the Prestone difference.
America goes and goes and goes with Prestone.
Well, you certainly couldn't think of the home field advantage, especially at noon when this game started. It was half a house full and a laid-back Southern California crowd in 80-degree weather, but I think the crowd's helping now.
Well, I think the home field advantage was proven in St. Louis, the way they turned out. The players talked about it. It affected the Dodgers so much that Mike Socia's wife, Ann Socia, was pleading with the fans to come out dressed in blue. So the crowd in St. Louis did it, and apparently today the Dodger crowd did it.
And we don't know, in case you weren't with us earlier, whether it was gamesmanship. Whitey Herzog refused to allow his team to be introduced and stand on the first base foul line, so the picture was really out of focus. The Dodgers were all lined up at third, and it was as if, really, they had given a ball game and nobody came.
And then that mound situation, we're not accusing anybody, but that was the Okefenokee Swamp out there.
Well, I think you're right when you said the dirt doesn't burn. But there's a lot of burning going on of intensity in each dugout. The Dodgers leading the Cardinals 4-1, and in the 6th inning, it'll be Tommy Herr, followed by Jack Clark, and then Andy Van Slyke. Bill Madlock now has 3 home runs and 8 runs batted in this league championship series. And in fact, take one away, make it 7 RBIs, because Guerrero's fly ball picked up the other. Ball one. It's that old story about, for want of a nail, the shoe was lost, for want of the shoe, the horse, the rider, the battle, and the war. And that one bouncer hit back to the box by Duncan sure gave Joaquin Andujar a bad inning. If you are historians of the game, you might remember the headlines in a Dodger-Yankee World Series back in Ebbets Field when Billy Lowe lost a bouncer in the sun, and the crowd thought he was making up a wild story, until you realize the When you stood on the mound in Ebbets Field, you had an upper and a lower deck, and you were facing west. And in the gap between the upper and the lower was the setting sun, and Lowe's actually did lose a ground ball in the setting sun. This one was a high bouncer that Andujar had to look up into the sun. Right. And to be truthful, Joe, an infielder, an outfielder, almost anyone else, they would have said, well, he lost it in the sun. It's a base hit.
Base hit, that's right. That was kind of odd. In fact, I had to hit down, and I had to change it to air.
2-2, the count to Tommy Herr, hit into a force play, single to drive in a run. How typical of him in the third inning. He has hit in all six. Fouled back. Among other things, he does everything else anyway. Second baseman, base stealer, RBI man, clutch hitter, and the Cardinal player representative. Not a bad guy to represent your club. Call me Mister. Naturally, that last name in German translates Mister. Trying to outthink him in a crouch behind the plate is the Dodger player rep, Mike Socia. 3-2. I'll tell you, Hershiser is falling into a pattern, and he started to fall into it in the fifth inning, and even as early as the third, he's trying to make perfect pitches, and when he does, all of a sudden, he's 3-1, 3-2, 2-0.
He tries to get too fine before he has to. There's no one on right now. The one thing you want to stay away from is the base on balls.
And he's gone 3-2 to Tommy Herr. Just missed. So Tommy Herr walks
first baseman
with all of his high wire act. That's the first walk, but it's enough to get Paranoski on the phone to the bullpen.
You know, we talked about it this summer, Ben. The control pitcher is the guy who puts good stuff on that 2-2 pitch. I mean, you get a guy that'll go 3-2, and then the guy hits it. You look at the stats, and it doesn't show many base on balls. You say, well, he's not wild. That isn't true.
That was Jerry Royce who got up, and I think Jerry Royce might begin to warm up. Batter is Jack Clark. Fastball popped in the air to right field. Marshall has to go back, but he's there. And Herr halfway. So one away as Clark. Now that's an interesting thing. As you look at Royce and Ken Howell, the right-hander. After Hershiser was pitching so deliberately to go 3-2 and walk Herr, Clark went after a pitch, obviously a little bit off the plate, or at least away. Flies to right field. Let's see what Van Slyke does. 0-2. Grounded out, fly to left. There was a quote attributed to Whitey Herzog, and they send up quotes to the press box, which is kind of interesting. Foul ball. One of the writers said to Whitey Herzog, why is Landrum playing instead of Cedeno? And the official quote on the sheet sent up to the press box, Herzog, quote, I just wrote Landrum's name down, end of quote. Oh, really? Cesar Cedeno is 0-13 against Oral Hershiser. Her at first, one out in the sixth. 0-1, the count to Andy Van Slyke and Terry Pendleton on deck. In left center. Landro shading Van Slyke to pull. And he goes the other way, but foul. So Tommy Herr back to first with one out. Dodgers scored in the first. Duncan doubled, Madlock singled him in. The Dodgers scored in the second. Brock walked, and Duncan singled him in. The Cardinals got a run in the third. Andujar doubled, and Herr singled him in. The Dodgers got two in the fifth. Duncan aboard on the high bouncer that Andujar lost in the sun. Scored on Guerrero's fly ball, and then Madlock homered. 0-2. One reason it's a good idea to update people, especially when you're on the West Coast. A lot of folks, the East Coast, three-hour time difference, just now getting off work and picking up the action. You've joined us. We're in the top of the sixth, one out, 4-1 Dodgers. Ground ball wide to first. Hershiser has to cover. Sachs hits him with the throw, and down to second goes Herr.
Hershiser really jammed him. Van Slyke, he had a good swing, but hit it right off the handle.
So with two out, Oral Hershiser will be working on Terry Fenelon. Don't forget tonight, exclusive coverage of the seventh and deciding game of the American League Championship Series. Pennant Fever underway at 8 Eastern. The League Championship Series, an inside look, followed by Game 7. The Blue Jays and the Royals live from Exhibition Stadium in Toronto. Bob Costas and Tony Kubek will be right there.
Certainly congratulations to both ball clubs. They have battled it right down to the seventh game.
Great series. Pendleton robbed of a hit by Duncan and hit back to the box. High bouncer to the right of Sachs. He backhands, gets him. So the Cardinals lead Tommy Herr, and at the end of 5.5, 4-1 Dodgers.
Lots of hustle, that's our repeat. That's why he's eating what the big boys eat. Loved his Wheaties since he was small. Now dig in, big boy, have a ball. Classic hits of crunchy wheat. Pure and simple, not too sweet. Dive right into those Wheaties feet. Now go tell your mama what the big boys eat.
It won't stop ringing.
When it touches my face, it hangs up.
Aww.
I don't have a problem. You got a problem.
Lots of people with phones not made by AT&T are registering some kind of complaint. When was the last time you had a complaint with an AT&T phone?
Hello? What?
Can you call me back on an AT&T phone?
You get what you pay for.
So sumptuous and luscious.
Cheese, marvelous cheese.
Makes everything scrumptious.
For exciting new ways to make your meals sing, come on into your grocer's today. Get new cheese ideas and a great variety of real cheeses that'll get you cooking. Make your meals sing with real cheese.
Game day. The NFL 85 locker room. Meet Ahmad Rashad. His beat is the glamour side of the street. You'll get exclusive interviews from a man who really knows his football.
We gotta get him his own dressing room.
Ahmad Rashad. He's been drafted for the team who's putting the fun back in football.
Walter O'Malley's dream came to fruition in 1962, and what a showplace it is indeed. Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles, the site of Game 6 of this National League Championship Series. Four runs, six hits, and no errors for the Dodgers. One run, six hits, and one error for the Cardinals. The starting pitchers are still there, Joaquin Andujar and Oral Hershiser. Bullpens are quiet. Campbell and Horton had been up once behind Andujar. Royce and Howell were up once behind Hershiser. And now it's Oral's chance to sit and cool, and Socia's chance to swing the bat. He's grounded out and singled, one for two. Foul ball. Not a bad idea, of course, with the right side of the infield deep and the third baseman fairly back.
He's got to be fairly back. Well, Mike, it's one thing he does not have, but the element of surprise works for you. I've seen some guys that you didn't think could run, and when they do bunt, it's almost like the infield says, did you see what he did?
Well, remember, in the fourth inning of the second game, he bunted for a base hit, and Brock followed with the home run. That's when Andujar fell down trying to field a bunt. Brock homered and made it 5-1, and that was that. The Dodgers are leading 4-1, and so she was trying to start it off again with a bunt. Ball two. Andujar is due to bat third when the Cardinals come up in the seventh inning. There's no one throwing in the pen. And he's had some very good hacks at Hershiser. Doubled, and he almost cut Madlock in half. 2-1. pitches in the second inning. Came close to walking Sachs, but Sachs wouldn't let him walk when he swung at a bad ball in the fourth inning. And he walked Sosa. Four times in six innings, Whitey Herzog has seen the Dodgers and Lasorda's crew get the leadoff man on base. Now it's Brock, and you see Bill Campbell down in the bullpen for St. Louis. Campbell can be getting ready for either way, to come in now or to come in after they hit for Andujar. We talked about the platooning. Cedeno and Van Slyke have three hits in 20 at-bats between them. Cabell and Brock have two hits in 22 at-bats. So the platooning for the Cardinals in right field and the Dodgers at first base has not done a thing to merit either side. The difference, of course, Brock did hit that two-run home run. 4-1 Dodgers, and at least up to here, a pattern has definitely been established in the series. If you score two runs or less, you lose. Score three or more, you win. High pop fly. It'll be Tommy Herr.
Trouble. He's got trouble. He really battled that. He had to flip the glasses up, and he had to really battle that sun. Watch, and he's still checking it right now. You can see he was in deep trouble, never gave up on the play. Now he's got the glasses down. He can't find it right here. Right here he's in trouble. Now he's looking, finds it. Battling it once again. I tell you, that was a good, good play because he never gave up and wasn't sure after he caught the ball.
So we've seen two, one by Tommy Herr, the other one by Terry Pendleton. Each time, they finally had to lift the sunglasses to find the ball. Here's Sachs. Slide to right, grounded to third. And popped up a bad ball again. I'll bet you that thing was way out of the strike zone. So he's just up there flailing away right now. Take a look at that pitch and see where it was. Way up. So he popped it up.
The riding fastball always looks so good to the hitter, but the power hitter is the guy you don't mind taking a whack at that one because that's what he's really looking for. But when you're batting in the eighth spot like Sachs, you look for him to punch that ball the opposite field in first and third for a while.
Hershiser single to right and grounded to third. So Sosa opens up with a walk. Brock pops up. Sachs flies out. Dodgers leading 4-1 in the sixth. Breaking ball. Bailed out on it. Porter, Landrum, and we'll see about Andujar when the Cardinals come up in the seventh. Campbell has just about stopped throwing in the Cardinal pen. See Porter indicating to Andujar, get that shoulder in and drive at the hitter. You're opening up.
He kind of just eased that curveball in there. He really didn't get into it. A pitcher like a hitter, if he opens up too soon, just loses his power and just doesn't drive into it. Drive into the pitch, drive into the ball with the bat. They're doing a lot of things in this game, staying with Andujar.
On the corner. Good pitch. 1-2.
Haven't seen a fastball yet. He sees a fastball. It's going to have some smoke on it, I'll tell you that. Wouldn't be surprised. This would be sidearm. In fact, Porter might just give him a sign and drop it down.
1-2. Got him with the breaking ball again. So the Dodgers get the leadoff walk to Sosa and lead him. 4-1 Dodgers. We'll be back after these messages from your local station.
Saturday on Hunter. A beautiful rich girl is getting away with murder.
That sweet little thing?
It's undercover danger when Hunter swings an action.
My words are fantastic. Hello, everyone. I'm Jennifer Blome. An audit of state funds used for desegregation shows that some money was spent on circus tickets, retreats, and banquets for the teachers. The city of St. Louis held a disaster drill today, but one-third of the warning sirens failed to work. And school officials in Collinsville are deliberating about what to do about two students whose father has AIDS. We'll have more news for you after the baseball game.
You say there's a difference, Kroger? Play ball.
Go Krogering and enjoy the big game with the all-American favorite, Wilson Corn King hot dogs. Just 69 cents for the 12-ounce package. And start your morning with the sizzling taste of Wilson Corn King bacon, only $1.29 a pound. Savor the flavor of 93% fat-free Wilson boneless ham. Just $5.49 for the 2-pound package.
Feel the difference.
That's big league.
Go Krogering.
Today, there are a lot of people telling you how to invest your money. And while it's fine to have a lot of financial options, what you want are financial solutions, resourceful solutions. That's what you'll find at Mercantile. When you bring your money here, you'll find people ready to listen to your goals and expectations, ready to match them to our products and services. Putting our resources to work to help your money make money. That's the solution we offer at Mercantile Bank, the resourceful bank.
Are computers invading your privacy? We'll show you tonight at 10.
This telecast, presented by authority of Major League Baseball, may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of Major League Baseball. We're going to the seventh inning at Dodger Stadium. Darryl Porter, followed by Tito Landrum, and then Joaquin Andujar, or a hitter. Andujar still fussing, and I'm sure at himself, over the fifth inning. It should be a 2-1 game, but the bouncer by Duncan that he lost in the sun undermined what is otherwise a strong effort. Guerrero's fly ball got a run home, and then Matlock homered, and he is seething in the Cardinal dugout.
Catcher Darryl Porter.
Cary Grant, who is one of the not celebrities who go to games. He is a baseball fan who happens to be a celebrity.
Looks like he's the eye in the sky. Look at him.
That's
realized.
His wife, Barbara. And he'll come out early enough just to watch batting practice. He is one of the few celebrities who really comes to see a game.
He acted like he was surprised to see himself on television.
Yeah. He's a marvel. Darryl Porter, Tito Landrum, and then we'll see about Andujar. First ball single. So after getting into a sloppy mood of pitching behind the hitters, Hershiser tried to start a hitter off with a strike, and Porter greets him with a single.
And it was the curveball. Porter hit that same curveball in the second inning and hit it in the same spot as Paranoski starts to get that bullpen ready.
Well, the last time, remember, Kenny Howell and Jerry Royce were up, and it would appear as if they'll go with the same combination. There's Royce, but there's Niedenfuhr, not Howell. Tito Landrum twice grounded to short. Andujar is out on deck. Fouled away. Second deck off to the right. So Joaquin evidently will take his turn, and there's no one throwing in the Cardinal bullpen. As we told you, Andujar has not been cheated. He has really had some good rips at the plate. 0-1. Almost hit him. One ball, one strike. Hershiser, in the first game that he pitched, appeared to get a little bit stronger as the evening went along. Now he's in the seventh inning. He has allowed seven hits. Ground ball up the middle. And it's a base hit. Porter will stop at second, and Hershiser's got the wobbles. As the Cardinals try to get off the floor and come back. And Andujar will now give way to Steve Braun.
Duncan gives it a good effort. He just wanted to knock that ball down, but just could not get to it.
And Ron Paranoski is out to the mound to talk to Hershiser, who began his wobbles in the fifth inning. Remember, he went 3-0 to Andujar, then went 3-2, and Andujar ripped one at Matlock. He went 3-2 to McGee, who singled. He got out of that inning. Then he walked Tommy Herr, opening up the sixth inning. And now in the seventh, back-to-back singles, and you know he's struggling. Steve Braun, who is the active Major League pinch hit leader with 113 coming up. Braun beat the Dodgers earlier this year here at Dodger Stadium with a pinch hit. So Andujar goes six innings and allows four runs, six hits. Ball one. On deck is Willie McGee. Then Ozzie Smith and then Tommy Herr. You have switch hitters three in a row. Steve Braun. Braun has had one at bat for Whitey Herzog, and he is 0-1. Dodgers 4, Cardinals 1, nobody out, Birds at first and second. And he's behind again. That has really been the big thing about Hershiser since the start of the fifth inning. He has been behind on almost every batter, and that's a sure sign he's laboring.
And he doesn't have that good, sharp, biting curveball that he is known for.
Big bouncer wide at first. Brock will have to feed Hershiser, and the runners move up 90 feet. So the play goes 3-1. Landrum advancing to second, and Porter to third. And Willie McGee coming up with first base open, representing the tying run. McGee twice grounded to short, and in the fifth inning, single to left, but was thrown out on a perfect throw from Mike Socia to Mariano Duncan.
Base hit McGee got was a fastball, the outside part of the plate. He hit it to the opposite field. They've been getting him out by pitching him off the strike. The strike zone, low and inside.
On the corner. 0-1. There wasn't very much on that. By that, I mean there wasn't any velocity. He just made a perfect pitch. 0-1. Fouled away. So he has McGee where he wants him. 0-2.
I'm sure Socia, when he goes out, as we look at Ozzie Smith, is just going to set up these pitches. If indeed he's going to waste this pitch because he's got in two strikes, where is he going to throw it? And then remind him of the scouting report, and that says he chases the ball. It's low and inside, out of the strike zone. He's got him down two strikes. He can work on him.
When he was striking out against Valenzuela, he was hitting right-handed, and he was chasing the ball both low and inside and low and outside. So let's see what happens as a left-handed batter. 0-2. Moment in the game. 4-1 Dodgers, and the Cardinals with a chance to get right back in it. Porter at third, Landrum at second. One out. Fastball fouled over the head of Hal Lanier.
It was not in the strike zone. It was up. Willie wasn't going to take any chances. Lucky it was out of the strike zone. I'm sure what you do in a spot like that is say, hey, man, you can't throw those like that. If you're going to throw like that, forget it. We'll go with the fastball. And the pitcher's got to talk you out of it.
Niedenfuhr and Royce down in the pen. 1-2 the count. Willie McGee trying to pick up a couple. Line drive, base hit. Will not only get Porter home, it'll get Landrum home, and it gets the Cardinals back in the game. And I'll be honest, That sure figures, because Hershiser is not pitching like anybody who's going to be around here very long.
That was a curveball, but again, it did not bite. It just didn't roll and bite into the watch. And it just kind of, it's kind of a flat curve. He stays right with it, and boom, right back up the middle.
And he's gone. Here comes Lasorda. I'm surprised the way he was pitching to Willie McGee. They must have been praying for a miracle, because he was anything but convincing. So Oral Hershiser, who was the only pitcher in the league championship series to come up with a complete game, will go out leading 4-3, but with a rabbit, the tying run at first base.
And I want to make this point now. George Case, a great base stealer in the American League, always said the best time to run is the first pitch after a relief pitcher comes in, because everybody's worried about getting everything going again. That's when he would take off.
Well, now you have Niedenfuhr and Jerry Royce. And they're going to go to Niedenfuhr. Boy, that's tough. You throw the big home run the other day, and you're right back in the fire.
Will you help me put on my tent?
Nope.
I'll give you a s'mores granola bar.
A s'mores granola bar?
1, 2, 3, 4, remember the taste of s'mores. They say the s'mores granola bars. S'mores granola bars.
Oh, boy.
Graham, chocolate, marshmallow, and more. Remember the taste of s'mores. S-M-O-R-E-S. Remember the taste of s'mores.
Roger, will you help me put up my tent?
Ralston brand s'mores chewy granola bars. Remember the taste?
The Kemper Cavalry. Why do so many people trust their auto and home insurance to Kemper?
First accident forgiveness.
Kemper Total, repair or replacement value coverage for my new car, as long as I own it.
Guaranteed renewal for good drivers 55 and over.
Compare Kemper's loyal protection with anyone. We don't have to toot our own horn. Once you compare Kemper, you'll ride with us.
Has the taste that goes great with all your favorite foods. A taste that makes Riuniti the world's best loved imported wine.
Everything's nice with Riuniti on ice. Riuniti, Riuniti.
Can it really be the day before yesterday? It seems like it just happened. Would you believe that it is Ozzie Smith coming up to face Tom Niedenfuhr? So the last pitch that Niedenfuhr made gave the Cardinals that dramatic victory. Now he comes in with Willie McGee at first, the tying run, and Ozzie Smith to be the batter.
Mentioning McGee, he had his foot on the bag and just... He still got his foot on the bag, just watching Niedenfuhr. Now there he's standing right there, just studying Niedenfuhr, even though he's just warming up. He's already made the mark. You can see it out there. He drew the line. Just barely see it there. Right there. We're going into it. That's the line Willie McGee drew. That's as far as he thinks he can get. Now, Mike Socha's got to do a little bit of soul searching here. He's looking for some help from the bench. Do they see something, maybe?
The home run that Ozzie Smith hit against Niedenfuhr the other day was only the seventh home run that Niedenfuhr had allowed this year, but he's allowed five since the 7th of September. And it gives you an idea that Lasorda has indeed lost considerable confidence in his bullpen, that he allowed Hershiser, who was definitely laboring, to go as far as he did. Check swing, fouled away.
McGee at first base doesn't really have to have a sign, or does he get a sign? He's another one of those rabbits that if he thinks he can go, make it go.
Stole 52 times, second base, stole third 4 times. for a total of 56. And of course, now he represents a tying run. And I don't know whether Brock was tied up on that or not.
He wants to make sure and just wants to know if there's anything going on here. The way they're playing him, it looks like they're hoping that Ozzy would try to pull that ball. Badlock at third base, as you look at the defense, they're kind of bunching him up the middle. There's the room between short and third.
Tommy Lasorda, who saw his team get out in front to a 4-1 lead, is now back to nail-biting. It is 4-3 Dodgers, and the Cardinals have McGee the tying run at first. In the seventh, one away. Ozzie is 1-for-3. The biggest pitch that Hershiser made early in the game was when he struck out Ozzie Smith in the third inning and a runner at third, and then immediately gave up back-to-back hits to her and Clark. 1-1.
The count that McGee ran on last time was 2 balls and 1 strike. It's 1-1 right now. But that doesn't mean that much, believe me. These guys run at any time. They'd run on New Year's Eve.
McGee not going, and the ball is hit to right field and down in the corner. It is going to be a one bouncer, and it's live. McGee is being waved around third. The overthrow will allow Ozzie to go to third. As Marshall Stroll went over Sax's head, that gave Ozzie Smith the extra base. And now you know why Lasorda was reluctant to go to the bullpen. And it is 4-4. By Ozzie Smith.
And again, he pulls it down the right field line. They were punching him up the middle, and Niedenfuhr, who throws way better than an average fastball, the last two times that Smith has faced him, he's pulled him. Marshall's relay, as you pointed out, Ben, missed the relay man, and now they've got a chance to pick up another run because the infield has to play in, and a tough, tough hitter up there, Tommy Herr.
And Lasorda's words come back now to echo and re-echo and haunt him. If they can beat Valenzuela and Hershiser, then we are not as good as we thought we were. Well, they were able to win the game that Valenzuela pitched, and they are able to come from 4-1 down to tie the Dodgers against Hershiser. So they'll walk her and get Jack Clark. We had mentioned it yesterday. There is no comparison between the two bullpens. The Cardinal bullpen, to give you an idea, Lottie, Daly, and Worrell retired 33 of the 40 batters they faced. The Dodger batting average against the Cardinal bullpen is 175. And the Cardinal bullpen allowed only one walk. The Dodger bullpen, very shaky. And now Howell and Royce are in the pen, and here is Jack Clark. And the Cardinals have a chance to get out in front and win it. Smith standing at third, representing the go-ahead run. Tommy Herr is at first. One out, and a fly ball hitter at the plate. Breaking ball miss. And Chetney had got the corner. 1-1. And Clark backs out.
You were like Jack Clark. You didn't believe it either.
1 ball and 1 strike to count.
Still doesn't believe it.
Fake once, fake twice. Nowhere to go. So the Dodgers led 1-0, 2-0, 2-1, 4-1, and the Cardinals have come scrapping back to tie it up. Dodgers come up in the bottom of the seventh. They have Mariano Duncan, Ken Landro, and Pedro Guerrero. Yeah.
standing at first, Tommy Herr. Over at third, Ozzie Smith. One out. Jack Clark at the plate, one and two the count. Popped it up, foul, and out of play. Socia coming back to the screen. No chance. There's a big difference between Busch Stadium in St. Louis and here at Dodger Stadium. One of it is the distance from home plate to the backstop. Here, it is 70 feet. That means a catcher has a chance at a lot of foul balls where he would not have the same chance at Busch Stadium to run out of real estate. One and two. Things that Niedenpuhr has to worry about is even the rabbits with her at first and Ozzie Smith at third. Ozzie with 31 stolen bases and her with 31.
He's not exactly stationary. Her, you can't take for granted he's going to turn into a spectator over there at first base.
Right. And then neither would Ozzie Smith if you throw through to get him. One and two. High pop fly down the right field line. Slicing foul. A trio and it's untouched.
That would have been interesting because they would have pulled off that play. Tommy Herr was tagging up, and what does the fielder do when he sees a man hit first to second? Does he throw to get him? Because if he does, Smith is going to come in. So he's really got you in no man's land. Eddie Stanky used to pull that play all the time.
They were in no man's land anyway because Brock and Sachs were out of either play. They were down in the tarp roller. Had either man caught the ball, they could not have gotten either Herr or Smith, I don't believe.
Well, Herr was ready to bait him. He was setting the trap. He was heading for second base.
One and two the count. One out. 4-4 in the seventh. Breaking ball missed.
Well, we talk about pressure on the ball players. What about these umpires? I mean, they have to umpire that ball. An awful lot at stake right here. And look at that pitch.
Tommy Herr taking his lead at first. Ozzie short lead down the line from third. One away. Four, top of the seventh.
He wants to set up the defense in case Herr takes off at first base. He's called in both Duncan and Sachs. He's got his instructions from the bench as to what he's going to do.
Since Ozzie Smith is the potential winning run, I would have a tendency to feel they would not throw through and that Socia would just take the ball, even if it meant walking Van Slyke to pitch to Pendleton. They might give Herr second base. Would be awfully dangerous on a delayed double steal. The only infielder to handle the ball would be Duncan, and he's deep. A left-hand hitter at the plate.
And he'd have to go through the full-arm bluff, hoping that maybe Ozzie Smith would break and he could pick him off there.
Yeah, I bet they would go to third immediately. There'd be no throw if Herr takes the second. We'll see. Ball one. Van Slyke grounded out twice. Fly to left, 0 for 3. But of course, all those at-bats were against Oral Hershiser. 4-4, seventh inning, as the Cardinals have come back. Down 4-1, they've caught the Dodgers. Fouled away, 1-1.
looking for a ride home. Andy Van Slyke trying to give it to him. And Tommy Herr over at first. Van Slyke, I think, has something in his eye, in his right eye. Timeout. And Jerry Crawford trying to help him.
Sometimes an eyelash will bother you. Musial was so meticulous that he would have them trimmed so nothing would get in his eye.
Need all the help you can get hitting a 90-mile-an-hour fastball. One ball and one strike. Fastball. Foul back. One and two. Down in the Cardinal bullpen, we'll put it to you this way. The last pitcher that we saw warming up was Todd Worrell. So we would assume it was Campbell when they were behind by three. It was Horton when it was 4-1. When they got it even, it was Worrell. And the Dodgers with Duncan, Landro, and Guerrero due up. Duncan switches, Landro's left, and Guerrero back right. Ozzie Smith at third, Tommy Herr at first. Two out, three runs over. 4-4 in the seventh.
When you're 100% pure beef,
the beef goes on.
When you're sear-sizzled, lean and juicy,
McDonald's beef goes on.
Your great beef taste goes on and on.
You're all beef, pure beef, lean and hot. So your big beef taste just won't stop. It's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's. The beef goes on.
Chances are you've spent today doing things for other people.
So, honey, could you remember to pick up my soup?
Don't you deserve something for yourself?
Susan, would you come in here and take a letter, please?
Treat yourself to Mon Cheri, the fine chocolate Europeans treasure most. Mon Cheri, the treasure chest of delicate chocolate and hazelnuts.
Hey, my phone's ringing.
Discover Mon Cheri, the brand of fine chocolate Europeans treasure most. You deserve it.
The following message is furnished by Major League Baseball.
1985 has been a great year for me and a record-breaking year for the family of baseball. Like any family, we've had our share of problems and we're working hard to solve them. But we've had some great performances too. Just take that young man in St. Louis and that kid on the mound in New York and that youngster like myself in Houston. From all of us in the family of baseball to all you families who cheered for us, thank you for sharing a great season.
Major League Baseball, a family tradition. Share it all.
We're going to the bottom of the seventh inning in a 4-4 tie. Andujar, in six innings, allowed four runs, two of them earned, six hits, three strikeouts, two walks. And Todd Worrell, who has been absolutely brilliant, come right back in. Look at those numbers. That was his regular season. And he's been better than that. He's been in three games in the league championship series. He's worked four and a third innings. And he has not allowed an earned run. He has allowed just two hits, no walks. He's the young man from nearby Arcadia who went to Biola College.
He just rears back and throws a almost above 90 fastball all the time. A little bit of a slider, and he gives a lot of credit to Fregosi. He was a starter, was having some problems, made him a reliever, comes in, pumps that fastball, gets out of jams, and Fregosi's advice, according to Todd, very simple. He said, hey, just because you're going to the big leagues, don't change. You've got a good arm, just throw strikes and you'll be all right. That certainly has proven out.
Well, we told you before, he came up from Louisville on the 26th of August, and since then, three wins, five saves, five for five in opportunities. In the regular season, he struck out 17 hitters in 17 appearances. Tonight, Game 7, 8 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. They'll decide the American League championships with the Royals and the Blue Jays.
Deeb against Saberhagen. That should be a dandy.
This isn't exactly a walk in the park either. 4-4, bottom of the seventh inning. Duncan, Landreau, and Guerrero. Ground ball inside first, and there's nobody there. Overshifted was Van Slyke, and Duncan is going to be waved to third. He is going to be in there. Van Slyke is arguing with the umpire in right field. I don't know if he's claiming interference from a fan or if Grungy was in the way. I think it was an interference with the fan he was claiming, but Grungy says no. Watch what happens here. He pulls it between Clark in the bag, and Van Slyke has a little bit of trouble. He plays the carom. Now watch what happens here. He kind of hesitates right there, and that's where he loses the play, and Mariano picks up the extra base.
There was no fan interference.
No,
no problem whatsoever. It was the complete surprise. Just as the Dodgers couldn't believe Ozzie Smith would pull down in the corner for three, the Cardinals couldn't believe Duncan would pull a 94-mile-an-hour fastball, but he did.
Grungy was right there, and yeah, I saw him motion by his hands, no interference.
The infield is up, and it's fouled away by Landreau. 4-4, bottom of the seventh, the tiebreaker 90 feet away, and Landreau, Guerrero, and Matlock trying to get him home. A single, a double, a triple, a stolen base, and quite a game in the field. He's at third. And that's a little pop fly. Her going out and makes the clutch catch, as he does all year long.
He had some problems with the sun, and he turned his back to the infield, made it doubly difficult. Hung right with it, and look at this. He finds the ball right here and makes an over the shoulder catch. And now Whitey Herzog wants to come out and talk to his pitcher. That Herr is something.
He is something indeed. Tommy Herr has saved the bacon for Todd Worrell, at least for the moment. Now the batter is Guerrero, followed by Matlock. Guerrero had popped up twice until he hit the fly ball in the fifth inning to drive in a run. All three of those at-bats were against Joaquin Andujar. And if you were not with us back in the third inning, Guerrero going after Andujar's drive re-injured his left wrist when he ran into the wall right by the little bullpen window. They are going to walk him intentionally. It will mean five intentional walks given to Guerrero in the series. So Matlock will be coming up with runners at first and third and one out in a 4-4 tie in the seventh inning.
If you ever wondered, when we talked about there's always one fellow on the other club that they have the clubhouse meeting and say, we don't want him to beat us, Guerrero is the man for the Cardinals as far as they're concerned. Man, he has really gotten the intentional walks in the clutch.
The Herzog is trying to get out of it on a double play with Matlock due out. So he takes the bat out of Guerrero's hand. Five intentional walks. And meanwhile, the man coming up leads both teams in RBIs in the championship series. Matlock has three home runs and seven RBIs. The infield goes back to double play depth. Of course, at the corners, Pendleton is near the bag, and Clark is holding on Guerrero. Ball one, breaking ball. Matlock hit the first pitch for a single in the first inning. And they're all on their feet at Dodger Stadium. Ground ball down to Ozzie. He'll go to her, and the throw to first is in time. And and they got out of the jam. Bill Madlock, 6-4, three double play. And the blue turns even bluer at the end of 7-4-4.
Cats aren't really that hard to please. You just have to show them who's boss. Boss, your dinner's ready, and it's tender fiddles. See? Cats are easy to please. Just give them exactly what they want, which is tender fiddles, exactly the way they like it. Roscoe likes his with dinner music.
Tender Fiddles brand cat food in 8 moist, easy-to-please flavors.
Can I stop whistling now? Don't talk with your mouth full.
Thinking of selling your home? Well, now may be the perfect time. Interest rates are at their lowest in years, and the Century 21 team has thousands of ready buyers. In fact, the Century 21 team sells more homes than any other. Want to sell your home? Call a Century 21 professional today and ask about a home market evaluation.
Put number one to work for you, Century 21.
Call now and let a Century 21 professional help sell your home.
Driven 10 hours a week, this toy could use $500 worth of alkaline batteries. Because when an alkaline battery goes dead, you throw it away. This is a GE rechargeable. When it goes dead, you don't throw it away. You do something revolutionary. You recharge it. So why spend $500 for alkaline batteries when you could spend less than $15 for two GE rechargeable batteries and a charger?
GE, we bring good things to life.
Game day. The NFL 85 locker room. Meet Pete Axtell, our own prognosticator and pundit. Here preparing his picks of the week. Though his calls can be controversial, you'll always get predictions with a point of view from Pete Axtell, part of the team that's putting the fun back in football.
It wasn't a crisp double play, and you kind of wondered why it took Ozzie so long, but watch where that ball hits, right on the edge, and it's a big hop, and he really has to wait for it, and Guerrero coming down doesn't get a close to Tommy Herr, and he puts extra on it, and they get him.
That, to me, was the difference, the only way they could have broken up the double play. Guerrero cannot possibly go straight into the bag. He has to go after the second baseman, and he failed to, and by going into the bag, there was no chance of preventing the double play. Now watch Duncan's reaction. But if Guerrero had chased her, I think they could have broken up the double play because of that big high bounced Ozzie.
But he had a little bit of time there, Herd did, and he really got out of the way. He was about 5 steps. Pedro really would have had to go after him. That was the intent, and if he gets him, he might slow him down.
Big moment, 8th inning now, 4-4, and Terry Pendleton at the plate, ball one.
Just as a footnote, you got to give Whitey some credit, and he took the monkey and put it right on his back and said, hey, walk Guerrero and set up the double play, and it's going to get lost in the box score, but it was a gutsy move.
You talk about a roller coaster of emotions. Just look at that 7th inning. First, the Cardinals are down 4-1. Then they rally, and not only tie it up, they have the tie-breaking run at third in Ozzie Smith, and Clark and Van Slyke strike out, and this place goes wild with relief. Then Duncan in the bottom of the 7th triples, and they go wild with ecstasy, only to be frustrated about the double play. 1-1. Slow ground ball. Sacks to drop. You know, Pendleton slides. Every scout I have ever talked to and every baseball man I have ever talked to says you waste it when you slide to first. If you continue to run, you have a better chance of making the play than sliding.
I would agree with that, except that when you're running, you think it helps you. You
Hell
try
yeah.
everything, and the adrenaline is pumping, and you want to get there so badly, so it's half smarts and half emotion, and that's what causes you to do that.
Well, here's Darryl Porter, single twice. It was his single in the 7th. That was the beginning of the end of Hershiser and a 4-1 lead. He pops it foul and out of play. 0-1. 4 runs, 10 hits, 1 error for the Cardinals. 4 runs, 7 hits, no errors for the Dodgers. Cardinals left runners at first and third in the 7th inning. And the Dodgers wound up leaving a runner at third in the 7th. It's Don
Tom Niedenfuhr and Todd Worrell. Ground ball hard to Brock. And he'll underhand to Niedenfuhr. Two down. Tito Landrum will be coming up, followed by Todd Worrell. The Dodgers in the bottom of the eighth will have Mike Marshall, Mike Socia, and Greg Brock. Landrum grounded to short, and then in the seventh inning, he too singled against Hershiser and came around to score. Worrell is on deck, so the Cardinal pen is quiet. Breaking ball, good one.
I'll repeat. That's why he's eating what the big boys eat. Loved his Wheaties since he was small. Now dig in, big boy, have a ball. Classic kids love crunchy wheat. Pure and simple, not too sweet. Dive right into those Wheaties feet. Now go tell your mama what the big boys eat.
The right parts. Mr. Goodwrench has the right parts for your GM car. Parts that fit. Parts engineered for your car by people who designed your car. Parts for every make and every model of virtually every GM car and light truck on the road today. Mr. Goodwrench can help you keep that great GM feeling with genuine GM parts because no one knows your GM car better. No one.
Jack Rafferty proves you just can't tell.
The fellas that I work with are pretty perceptive. They don't miss too much. No one had picked up the fact that the gray was gone from my hair. It was that simple. No one realized I was using the Grecian Formula 16. It was so gradual. The Grecian has a natural look about it. It's not a dye. It's a clear liquid. The questions most asked by the fellas at work were, what are you doing? You're working out? Are you losing weight? And unless I told them I was using the Grecian Formula 16, they never would have guessed.
Grecian Formula 16. You just can't tell who's using it.
Game 6 of the 1985 National League Championship Series is brought to you by Ralston Purina Company, makers of Purina Pet Foods and other fine products from Checkerboard Square. By Kemper and the independent insurance agents who represent us. For all of your insurance needs, ride with Kemper. By Light Beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less. And by Wheaties. Crispy, crunchy, tasty wheat. Wheaties, what the big boys eat. 55,208 have filled Dodger Stadium. And they're looking at a gem, a 4-4 tie in the bottom of the eighth. High fly ball into right center. Van Slyke and McGee, and it's going to be over the wall. I can't believe that ball carried out.
seen it. I've seen it. The ball just kept carrying and carrying, and he just ran out of room.
One ball and no strikes to Mike Socha. Ball two. So it is 5-4 Dodgers, and the Moose, as they call him, will give the Buffalo, as they call Needham Buehr, something to lean on. And Herzog is leaning on the railing. By the way, when the Cardinals come up in the ninth inning, they will have a hitter for Worrell, then Willie McGee, and would you believe Ozzie Smith? Right. 2-1. Breaking ball. 2-2. So the first run that Todd Worrell gives up in the league championship series. Fly ball to right center field for a home run. Fastball. That's hit to right. Van Slyke, good coverage, gets over there, fighting the sun. Boy, was that a tough play. In fact, everything hit in the air is a tough play.
Every ball in the air is an adventure. It's a high sky. We point that out. Bright sun shining, and watch Van Slyke battle it. He's got the glasses down, glove is up, and he's not sure of it at all. He's going to try to play it sideways, and it hit the glove, and he just clamps it.
It's like groping for a shoe at the bottom of a dark closet. You just kind of hope that it's there, and that's about where it was, there. Ball one to Brock. Walk, fly to center, pop the second, 0-2. 5-4 Dodgers, bottom of the eighth in game six. Away, ball two. Brock has just one hit in 12 at-bats, but that was the two-run home run against Andujar in game two. Seventh game tomorrow night. Bob Welch would figure to start for the Dodgers and John Tudor for St. Louis. Ball three. On deck, Steve Sachs, who has been a very anxious and impatient hitter in his other three at-bats. 3-1. He's swinging if he likes it. Ball four. So righty Herzog, you've seen his big right-hander give up a triple with nobody out and get away with it, and then the towering fly ball home run. The only two hits, and now here is Sachs. Flied to right in the second inning. Swung at a 3-2 pitch that would have been ball four and grounded out in the fourth. Went after a pitch above his shoulders and flied out in the sixth. But the town is all Marshalltown right now as he and Kenny Landro talk about it. Sachs 0-3, hitting .316 in the series. Four runs, 10 hits. Good breaking ball. 1-1. Boy, the last two innings, triple by Duncan, triple by Ozzie Smith, home run by Marshall. 1-1. Punched on the ground, foul, foul ball. About it, Jack. 0-2 the count. Brock is just being informed by Bruce Fleming that the ball was foul.
I'll tell you, that's the only thing he could do is ask the umpire. I mean, I've seen ball players ask the other players, and they'll say, oh, yeah, foul ball. And you walk off, and boom, they'll tag you.
Four Dodgers, one out, bottom of the eighth. 0-2 to Sacks. Breaking ball away, 1-2.
Put the play on last time this count.
We have Tom Niedenfuhr coming up, and no one throwing in the Dodger bullpen for the moment. It back. Dodgers led 2-0, 2-1, 4-1. Well, the Cardinals came back to prove their mettle with 3 in the 7th. Chase Hershiser and tie it up. And the Dodgers have untied it with a home run by Marshall in the bottom of the 8th. It is 5-4 in favor of the Dodgers. Did get a piece of it. Breaking ball. He's not seeing fast stuff.
High one, too.
Yeah.
Well, Vance Leick really got above that fence on that attempt of Marshall's. He didn't get a chance to make that play.
For 1,000 years, I've always been taught, just watch the outfielder. And in watching Vance Leick and McGee, it looked like they had it all the way, and suddenly it was gone. Did that thing ever carry? Of course, remember, it's in the high 80s here today. Fastball. So after all the breaking balls, he gives him the express to blow him down. And Tom Niedenfuhr coming up. You know, the temperature has a great deal to do with the flight of the ball. And it certainly will carry on a hot afternoon with a light breeze blowing out. They tell me in the old days, the old days, the home teams used to take the baseballs and put them in the ice box and then bring them out ice cold because the home run hitting opposition couldn't hit them out.
It'd be like hitting rocks.
Yeah. Well, here's Niedenfuhr. If you look at the Cardinal bench, Worrell is due up, of course. To face Niedenfuhr, who would you use? Cedeno, DeJesus, Harper, Jorgensen, Lawless, or Nieto? I guess you'd have to guess Jorgensen. 1-1. We'll see. Whitey's used one pinch hitter, Steve Braun. 1-2. So Mike Marshall, for the moment, enjoying the glory. But it is such a transitory thing. What have you done for me lately?
Last time at bat.
1-2. That'll do it for Tom Niedenfuhr. But Marshall will get an ovation as he trots to right field. And as we go to the 9th inning, hard hats and safety belts.
A day in the country. That's something to look forward to. And so is Ford Tempo, the car that shows a lot of forward thinking. Front-wheel drive, precise handling, fuel injection. And Tempo has a design that helps it hold the road. You'll also find Tempo makes the return home again.
Hey, look at the sheep!
A lot more fun.
Look, there's a baby!
Get 8.8 financing on 5-speed manual transmission Ford Tempos now.
There are dog foods that may have extra protein, but only High Pro helps give your dog that High Pro glow.
Healthy High Pro glow. Energy improved High Pro.
You improved High Pro. Now it's even more digestible with no fillers to give your dog more usable protein on the inside for more of that High Pro glow on the outside.
Healthy High Pro glow. Energy improved High Pro.
Try new improved Purina High Pro.
Professional dental technicians use instruments like this to remove denture stain. Effordent's powerful blue action formula can help you keep that professional looking clean. Professional strength Effordent removes even stubborn stains between teeth.
A simple fact, this plus this reduce more plaque than this alone.
Listerine reduces plaque by up to 50% over brushing alone for better oral hygiene. Listerine, it fights plaque and bad breath, and that's a fact.
Sunday, Alfred Hitchcock presents a wife.
Yes.
A lover. A killer.
Dead.
Or is she? Hitchcock, Sunday.
We've come to the ninth inning. The Dodgers, trying to stay alive, are leading because of this man, Mike Marshall's towering home run, clearing the right center field barrier, despite a tremendous effort by Andy Van Slyke to climb the ladder and get it. 5 runs, 8 hits for the Dodgers, 4 runs, 10 hits for the Cardinals. Dave Anderson will now take over at third base for the Dodgers. And Cesar Cedeno will be the first man to come up and hit. Cedeno, McGee, and Smith will take one more look at the home run and at the great effort by Van Slyke, who thought he had it until he ran out of room.
Look how high he gets, over the fence.
Cesar Cedeno.
Cedeno will take a pitch to try to set you up. I asked him about taking that 2-0 pitch all the way in St. Louis, and he said, well, I wanted to see where he was going to spot that because I figured he would come back if he throws it for a strike. Well, he's a thinking man's hitter up there.
So Cedeno starting it off, batting for Todd Worrell. 55,208 sitting in on game 6. Tom Niedenpuehr, who was killed by Ozzie Smith's home run and almost wrecked in the 7th inning by Ozzie's triple, now trying to salvage out of the wreckage here in the 9th. Ball one. He's backed up in the Dodger bullpen, Ken Howell and Jerry Royce. Royce has rarely relieved, and Howell has been ineffective. Series, one of them a double. But he had big numbers for the year. He was 291. The executive producer of NBC Sports, Michael Weissman. The coordinating producer of baseball, Harry Coyle. Today's game produced by George Finkel, directed by Harry Coyle. Technical director, Ray Figelski. 2-1. Strike two.
That was a absolute perfect pitch. Outside corner, low fastball in the 90s.
A reminder that nightly news following baseball, with the exception on the West Coast, where it will be seen at its regular time. 2-2. Fouled away.
It was a 93-mile-an-hour fastball he hit the corner with.
I swear to you, and I know Herzog watches, and I know Lasorda counsels clock guns, but I'm really starting to doubt him. Mariano Duncan pulls a 94-mile-an-hour fastball into the right field corner.
It tells you how fast, but it doesn't tell you if the ball is moving. And if the ball's not moving, the hitter's going to be moving around the bases.
Doesn't mean much. 2-2. On the hands, got him. Boy, was that a great location.
Perfect. High and tight, low and away. Low and away for the second strike. Watch this one. Even if he hits it, he's not going to go anywhere with it. In on the hands. Look at the ball was right at the handles.
That's the fastest he has thrown a 95-mile-an-hour fastball tonight. Right here on NBC. The thrills continue at 8 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. The final game of the American League Championship Series. The Royals and the Blue Jays. Here's McGee. 4-1. That's 3 strikeouts for Tom Niedenpuehr. Lasorda can't bear to watch. He has gone behind Bill Schumard, standing there, and he is up in the runway. He can't stand to watch it. 1-1. And don't forget who's waiting on deck.
Cardinal defense is Shane McGee towards left field.
One and two to Willie. And it's lined to left field. Base hit. So the tying run is aboard, and it's a guy who can motor. And here comes Ozzie.
Ozzie Smith.
That for McGee is his third hit in the game. Ozzie has singled and tripled. McGee, standing at first, was thrown out trying to steal in the fifth. Ozzie homered to beat Needham Fuhr and then tripled in the seventh inning today. And now let's watch this battle. Off the rubber. Good breaking ball. Ozzie quit on it, thinking it was going to be high and outside, and it dipped in. Needham Fuhr does throw a split-fingered fastball. 0-1. Ozzie hit his only home run of his life left-handed on a fastball from Needham Fuhr, and then he tripled in an over 90-mile-an-hour fastball into the right field corner in the seventh inning. There goes McGee. Sosa's throwing a bounce. He's stolen it.
Mike kept looking to the bench, see if they could give him some help. Here comes Peranowski out to talk to Needham Fuhr now, and Mike rushed that throw. That's the only way you can explain it. McGee, a good jump, running straight up. But with that great speed, he can erase some of the deficiencies maybe in his techniques and makes it easily. I tell you, there's no substitute for speed. Maybe you should run down. Maybe you should be in line. It would help you, but he can really run. Sosa just rushed that throw, and it's McGee's speed that made him do that.
The Dodgers had gotten McGee 3 out of 4 times. But take another look at that hurried throw, which was on a bounce.
Certainly was a good ball to handle, almost like a pitch out. He just threw it right into the ground. Sometimes if ball skips off that grass and really helps, but not this time.
It might have helped on AstroTurf, but not here. One ball, one strike, one out. Tying run at second. Ozzie Smith 2 for 4 at the plate. Fouled away. 1-2.
Not that McGee's going to try anything, but I keep saying it. I've said it, I guess, 100 times. You can't take it for granted. Now, Sachs is way over. The only man he has to worry about is Duncan. Now, look where Sachs is playing. So he can get himself a pretty good lead. If Needham Fuhr goes to sleep at all, he's going to find McGee perched at third.
McGee has stolen third 4 out of 6 times in the regular season. Anderson right near the bag at third. And Duncan kind of bird-dogged McGee. 1-2 to Ozzie Smith. 2-2. On deck, Mr. Clutch, Tommy Herr, and doesn't Tommy Lasorda know it? He couldn't stand it in a runway, so he's back in there. Herzog has been draped over the railing since the start of the game. 5-4 Dodgers, ninth inning. The tying run at second with one out. Bluff. It's amazing the way the Dodgers are playing. You would figure they would play Ozzie a slap hitter, not to pull, but they have got themselves overly committed to the right side since Smith has burned Needham Fuhr 2 at-bats. That was the split finger job, and he missed with it 3-2.
On the left in the outfield, they're kind of shading him a little bit towards left center field. Guerrero not too deep in left. Look at the room in right center field as we move over towards left field. You see Landreau on the left field side of second base.
Well, he pitched him into the home run. He pitched him into the triple. What does he do? 3-2. Away. Ball 4. And now Lasorda is really in the deep water. Boy, you talk about that whale that's stranded in the river up near Sacramento with nowhere to go. Lasorda is thinking now about the running game of McGee and Smith. He is really thinking about the possibility of some wheels with Tommy Herr, the batter. Smith at first, McGee at second, one out in the ninth, 5-4 Dodgers. Herr hit into a force play, singled in a run, walked twice, and as usual, made a clutch catch in the seventh inning. Right. 5-4 Dodgers, one out in the ninth. People seeing things with their heart instead of their eyes. That was a classic case of it.
He just went the other way, and Anderson is right there. Look at his right foot in foul territory. I point out, Ben, Ozzie Smith able to get a good lead off first base because they're playing behind him, obviously, and that may make a difference when they try to go to second base if there is a ground ball hit.
Willie McGee at second, Ozzie Smith at first, one out in the ninth, 5-4 Dodgers. Block. All the pressure would be on the Dodgers. Cardinals lose, it means they have another hotel bill. 0-2 to Tommy Herr. Fastball line foul.
That's why the Sorters got Royce and whoever in that bullpen. Dodgers lose, their pitching staff will go with 6 months rest.
See you in Vero Beach. Kenny Howell and Jerry Royce throwing in the shadows, but it's Tom Niedenfuhr. Well, you talk about relief pitchers and pressure and earning your keep. This is it.
Relief pitchers, it's like learning to swim by having somebody throw you in deep water. Danger's there. You have to think about it.
Bomb squad disposal.
You got it.
0-2 to her. Block.
Then you get those jackrabbits like McGee and Smith on there, and you have to think about that. Extra pressure, the crunch, the feel of ice closing.
No balls and two strikes to Tommy Herr. And how do you like this situation? The tying and possible winning runs are in scoring position with two out and Jack Clark coming up. The only play,
Niedenfuhr gets there in plenty of time. Brock is going to make sure.
The Herzog and his partner Red Shane Deans, meanwhile, in reading was sort of talking about walk him and pitch to that blank Van Slyke. That's what he just muttered in the dugout. I think it was a rhetorical question. Do I walk him and pitch to that so-and-so? He's not going to walk him. It is Jack Clark and Tom Niedenfuhr going head-to-head and the ball game on the line and the crowd on its feet. One way or another, what a way to end. Socia's going out to the mound.
Well, they want to make sure of the signs. They got Ozzie Smith at second base, and obviously he was switching signs. Niedenfuhr looked like he was going to pitch off the stretch. He's worried about McGee, and then he had a little bit of doubt in his mind as to what the signs were, and Socia's going to make them as simple as he possibly can because He's got enough to worry about with the two base runners and the batter without worrying about whether he gets the signs right. So make them simple.
Just so that we can cover the situation for you, Ozzie Smith at second, but Willie McGee at third has never tried to steal home this year. I'm not saying it's even crossed anybody's mind, but it might have crossed yours. Here's Clark, 1-for-4. Jack hit into a force play, hit a fly ball single to left, flied to right on the first pitch, and struck out. And he hits one to deep left field, and that one is gone. And Lasorda got the answer to his retirement. Short amount of time.
That's as slow a trip as Jack Clark ever made. I mean, he takes a lot of time.
There's McGee.
Look at Socia just kneeling in disbelief. Now watch the players. Here they come out, but they made it up. They're not going to block home plate. They're all going to stop short.
Life goes on for Niedenfuhr, pitching to that blankety blank, as Lasorda called him, Andy Van Slyke. Of the ninth, the Dodgers will have Mariano Duncan, Ken Landreau, and Pedro Guerrero. With first base open, they pitch to Jack Clark, and they might live with that thought all winter long. 7-5 St. Louis. Popped up around the plate, and it'll be Socia or Anderson. Socia. The St. Louis Cardinals with a big three in the ninth inning. And at the end of 8.5, it is 7-5 St. Louis.
He's not a national hero, but every year, thousands of people turn to him for protection. He's an independent insurance agent who rides with the Kemper Cavalry. He knows insurance. His job is to scout out the best values for your auto, home, life, health, or business. And when the chips are down, he's a good man to have on your side. Once you compare Kemper, you'll ride with us.
Hershey Bar, one of the old-time greats.
Hershey. Hershey.
When you want pure milk chocolate, with or without almonds, nothing but a Hershey bar will do. One of the old-time greats.
Nate and his pal Stan are painting guys who really prize those two scoops of plump, juicy raisins in Kellogg's Raisin Bran. They got the job in hand. They're rolling walls, but Nate recalls those two scoops and fiber-rich bran.
Two scoops. I'm going back again.
He can't resist the tastiness in Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
Two scoops.
To add to that footnote, Jack Clark had one RBI in the league championship series until he hit that dramatic ninth inning three-run home run to turn what looked like a 5-4 Dodger victory into a 7-5 Cardinal lead.
That welcoming committee was there. I mean, everybody.
I'll tell you how shocking it was to the Dodgers. This year, the Dodgers were 85-1 when leading after eight innings in a game. That one loss was way back in April to Houston. So if they look like they're in a state of shock, they are.
Looks like a painting.
Niedenfuhr has left the dugout. He went back into the clubhouse. Mariano Duncan, Enos Cabell, and Pedro Guerrero will go against left-hander Ken Daly. Daly pitched 2 2/3 innings the day before yesterday. He also pitched in the Danny Cox game, and he pitched in Andujar's first game, and he pitched in Tudor's game. Right. So Ken Daly is in his fifth game. He has saved one, and his earned run average is zero. And the bullpen difference, it looked like this time it was going to go to the Dodgers when Marshall hit the home run. But it has reverted again. Fouled away. Mariano Duncan, who had a single, a double, a triple, a stolen base, scored twice. One RBI, and Brock and Yeager and Maldonado and the other Dodgers sit numb in the dugout. 0-2. 4-1. But the thing I remember more as you look at Marshall, we were talking about what a transitory thing it was. He hit the home run to give the Dodgers the 5-4 lead. He hardly had a minute to enjoy it. 1-2. Strike three called. All the weight, however, has to rest within the heart and on the shoulders of Tommy Lasorda. And I could read part of his lips as he walked by. Am I going to walk him, meaning Clark, and pitch to that so-and-so?
23.
Van Slyke. And he opted to pitch to Clark with first base open. Kabloom.
He had to make the choice when it had to be made.
And it was a move, right-hand pitcher, right-hand batter. One out. Cabell up there batting for Kenny Landro.
It's been said many times that good pitching staff will make a good manager, a good bullpen will make a great manager. It's proved out here.
The thing that has, and of course it's going way back, but it has changed a lot of things around here, was Steve Howe and what happened to him.
Got to have that guy to come in out of the pen. Whitey has really done it. When they lost Bruce Sutter, they thought that was it.
1-1 to Cabell, one out in the ninth, 7-5 St. Louis. They are two outs away from the World Series. And the Dodgers are two outs away from a long, cold winter. The Dodgers blew a 4-1 lead with a 19-game winner, as you look at Fernando. They came into this game as Mike Socha is riveted to his seat, knowing that every game had been decided by a win for the home team for the last 13 straight. They knew Hershiser had won 12 straight. And as if they didn't know him, they know Jack Clark one day better. Strike three. And in Los Angeles, we are one out away from football. Interesting, the Dodgers won the first two games of the series. Six times, teams have come back losing the first two games of a World Series. Three of the six times involved the Dodgers. And it looks like it's going to be 4 out of 7. Popped up. We are this close to it. And St. Louis is going to the series. And they deserve it. They stopped Valenzuela. They spotted Hershiser, a 4-1 lead. tribute to the Cardinals, they did what they had to do and beat the Dodgers 7-5. A worthy champion of the National League and a worthy representative to go into the World Series. And the Dodgers come up a buck short.
Sorry, girls, but I gotta let some of you go.
Some working mothers are out of a job because you insist on eating Chex brand cereals without the milk. Don't you realize that Chex was designed to go with milk? Just enough milk gets trapped between the spaces to bring the true grain taste out while keeping the hearty crisp in.
Well, do you type?
So please, for them, for you, don't eat Chex without the milk.
They say there's no easy way to move California oil to Texas refineries.
Too far.
Cost too much.
But Goodyear said,
let's break new ground.
And arranged to build an oil pipeline.
Goodyear did?
Yep. Through Celeron, our oil and gas group.
The pipeline will run 1,700 miles and move the oil at lower cost than any other way. So much for what they say. Goodyear.
Do I hear 3800? Santa Fe?
AT&T is in antiques. With AT&T Alliance Teleconferencing Service, an antique dealer can easily hold an auction with clients all over the country at the same time. As clear as if they're in the same room.
All right, Chicago, it's yours. Now,
another reason to choose AT&T Long Distance Services. Talk with us. AT&T, the right choice.
Today's NBC light beer from Miller player of the game is the Cardinals' Jack Clark. Light beer from Miller, happy to present a check for $1,000 in the name of Jack Clark to help fight multiple sclerosis. Jack being doused by the champagne, coming up with a three-run home run when the Dodgers opted to pitch to him with first base open. And, of course, that will haunt Lasorda. He didn't have a left-hander to come in to pitch to Van Slyke, and he didn't have a right-hander then to really come in and counter another Herzog move.
It's pretty obvious. The managers always have the reasons, but the second guess is going to get him. Everybody's going to say, why didn't he walk him? You know that Clark can hit, and he's been able to handle Van Slyke. He only had one guess. He made it and got burned, but you got your best relief pitcher out there, and you have to give credit to Clark, who had to come back because he was up in a clutch situation earlier and didn't do anything. This time he did, and the Cardinals, who battled back all year, are going to be in the World Series, and there you see it. That pretty much says it all.
That's Mike Marshall, who for one brief shining moment turned this place into Camelot when he hit the home run in the bottom of the eighth. But fame and fortune, such a transitory thing. 1 minute Marshall was the hero, and the next minute he's lost in the shuffle. But when you look at it, the Cardinals are the better team and deserve to go. They were down 2-0. They got their act together and won 4 in a row.
And they beat the best.
And they beat the best the Dodgers had. What a year for the Cardinals. And the magic began when they got home to St. Louis.
And things to take by storm as we go along.
got down early, and we got their best pitcher going. He hadn't been beat all year here, 12-0, and we came back, and Ozzie Smith got an awful big hit.
When you consider those things with Hershiser, when you were down 4-1, were you thinking seventh game?
Not really, because we've been hitting the ball pretty good off of him. Even in the ball game, he beat us 8-2 the other night. We hit the ball fairly hard, but we didn't stay close enough to do anything. Today, I got to give him a lot of credit. I don't think he had his good stuff, and he kept battling, and he bent a little bit, but he really didn't break. But Ozzie Smith again got the big hit off of Niedenfuhr to tie the ball game. And of course, then he struck out Jack with a man on third and one out, and Jack got back at him. In the ninth inning, he had a pitch to him, and Jack nailed one.
It looked like Lasorda was thinking about it. Did you think they were going to walk Clark?
Well, you know, a manager only has, he's got to make a guess, and I think he wanted to go strength against strength, and it's just one of those things that happen, but I don't think you can second guess that.
We got to go. Thank you very much, Wade. Let's send you back upstairs.
Okay, remember tonight, Game 7 of the American League Championship featuring Dave Steeb and Brett Saberhagen. That's at 8 p.m. Eastern Time on NBC. For Joe Garagiola, this is Vin Scully. So long, and thanks for the ride.
A promotional fee has been paid to NBC by United Airlines. You're not just flying.